I do the same thing I told you that I never would. I told you I changed, even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay, need you to stay. I get drunk, wake up, I'm wasted still. I realize the time that I wasted. I feel like you can't feel the way I feel. I'll be if you can't be right. Can't be right. Yeah. I do the same thing I told you that I never would. I told you I changed, even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay, need you to stay. I do the same thing I told you that I never would. I told you I changed, even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay, need you to stay.
When I'm away from you, I miss your touch. You're the reason I believe in love. For me to trust, and I'm afraid that I'ma f*** it up. Ain't no way that I can leave you stranded, 'cause you ain't never left me empty handed. And you know that I can't live without you. So baby, stay. Oh, 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 oh. I'd be if you can't be right here.
I do the same thing I told you that I never would. Told you I changed, even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay, need you to stay, yeah. I do the same thing I told you that I never would. I told you I changed, even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach. Portions of the following program have been pre-recorded.
So what is that song that you just never, ever get sick of? That is just always great, and every single time, like going, oh my gosh, I can listen to this time and time again. I've got a pocket of those songs that every time I hear it, it's just like, oh my gosh, it's just the best thing ever. I would never hit forward if it came through on streaming.
There are certain songs that I've been listening since I was a child that I'll still go back and listen to, and it's almost as if I pick new things up out of it. That blows my mind.
I think some of them, too, they're just so ingrained with good memories that every time you do, it's just kind of that endorphin rush of you feel great, and you're just like, oh, man. And to you, at least, it is maybe the perfect song.
And don't you love when it happens? And this doesn't always happen. You'll be walking somewhere. Maybe you're in Publix, or maybe you're and you hear a song for the first time. You've never heard it before, but just that first time, you fall in love love it first year.
Mm-hmm. It's a beautiful thing.
Every time I'm in Publix, I know that song. Every song they play is a banger. Whoever put together Publix playlist, y'all know what y'all doing.
I'm not going to lie. My Publix time is probably 15 minutes. I overstay because of the playlist.
I'm always that person. They're singing. Mm-hmm. And then somebody will look at you like, shut up. And I just keep singing.
You're like, oh, there's that annoying Virginia.
With that witch-ass voice.
I have to tell you, I think Whole Foods is better.
Oh, get out of here. You are crazy.
Their playlist, you think, is better?
They play a lot of Muse.
I don't know.
Too cool for the world.
Coldplay.
As you're buying $45 tomatoes,
Whole Foods is a better
playlist. Why is this tomato $45, Kevin?
I don't care. I'm not gonna stick up for that, but I will tell you the music's better.
You gotta afford those music rights. That's why the tomatoes.
Whole Foods thinks it's too cool.
Yeah, turn up the B side of Muse as
it's better.
$58 for pineapple, everybody.
It's better playlist.
Price check on pineapple. Oh, it's $300. Mm-hmm.
Regular people can't shop at Whole Foods. I'm just saying.
Oh, when I'm going to Whole Foods, it's vacation time. Oh.
Or I just got a bonus.
Just got a paycheck. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what is that song that you never get sick of? That's what we have today for the playlist playoff. Here is my three.
Say what you say.
Oasis.
Say that you stay forever and a day in the time of my life.
Such a good song.
Because I need more time. Yes, I need more time.
song at Whole Foods.
You only hear this one at Publix.
As you're giving them so much money.
Duran Duran.
What is this Kevin sex song right here?
It is, yeah, Summer of Kev. Three songs I never get sick of.
Don't Go Away by Oasis is such a great song.
It really is.
Oh, I love that song.
It's next level.
That's you. You're flying out. Dude, the plane's going into the sky. That song just goes on.
Yeah, the clouds are all around you. Oh, it's just a beautiful setting. Yeah.
You don't want to get a drink after this?
That playlist makes me want to drink.
I don't feel good.
Yeah, I don't want to drink anything else.
I just had the grossest milkshake of my life. The last thing I want to do is go drink. I need to go lay.
Me and Kevin will get some drinks and you can get some Pepto.
I need to go make a number two.
I feel like my stomach is expanding.
I don't feel right.
No, I don't either. Somebody fake punched me. I don't even know what happened.
Okay, here's Virginia's playlist of the song you never get sick of. The Weeknd. Are you too with the sex music?
Perfect time of year.
Oh, yeah. This could have made my list,
such
too.
Such a chill
somewhere
song.
Somewhere far away from here. I feel fine enough, I guess. Considering everything's a mess.
Super chill song.
I love The Killers, and I'm surprised at how popular that song is. It's so massively popular.
It's so insane. Good. Yeah. You can't help but tap your little toes.
It does. It's a grooving song, man.
They have songs. My oldest son went to the school in Michigan, and their football games, they play that song. And
goes off.
Everybody sings, like, verbatim. And, you know, he's 24?
Yeah.
So the young kids love that song.
It's got everything you want in a song.
It really does.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here's where the room turns.
No. It'll turn again on me.
But I'm going with the ones that are true. Yeah. These are songs I've never gotten sick of, and I've heard them a billion times.
Can we predict the artist?
Go for it.
Billy Joel.
Billy Joel's Vienna's got to be in here. Or Summer Highland Falls. Or both.
Both. Yeah. And then a James Taylor song.
No, I know James Taylor makes everyone really angry, so I...
Okay, here's what the Bird's got for these songs he never gets sick of.
Now I have seen that sad surrender.
There you go.
Billy.
Summer Highland Falls.
Big Ball Billy.
I can
Billy.
Only stand apart and sympathize. For we are always what our situations hand us. See the sadness all. But you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want, or you can just get old, you're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? Day after
day. Oh, man. Great song.
Night after night, my heartbeat shows the fear. Goes to fear and fade.
I love that song.
That is such a great song. Yeah.
I
come
love
back
that
another day.
That's I've never gotten sick of that
I
song.
I got that to my list, too.
It's a good one.
Never get sick of that one. And here we go with Denny's for the playlist playoff. The songs he never gets sick of.
I'm a little bit more alternative than you guys.
Don't tell me you put Because I Got High in there.
No, but I do love that song.
I got to fight with a chat rumor.
Temper Trap, you guys know the song?
Oh, my gosh, I know this song.
I love this song.
This is a great song. I agree. It's a great song.
This one, I know you like that.
Oh, yeah. High and Dry, baby.
I love this song.
Radiohead. Great song.
yeah, yes.
Oh, yeah. That's a good song.
It was their only hit.
Yeah. Man, good stuff. Dang. I just died. Man, what, you guys all got good songs.
I thought everybody had good songs. I put together a Spotify playlist of everybody.
You had good songs.
You had good songs. You had good songs. You had good songs.
I stand on my songs.
That's a lot of butt kissing.
I'm fighting with the chat room. This sucks. No, it doesn't.
Bert, don't read the comments.
I like to be involved with the people.
You love your songs.
I don't ignore our audience.
You love Billy Joel, even though it's a little tired at this point.
That's what this is, it's about. It'll be tired lists.
Because you just can't get enough KVJ. The KVJ Replay on 97.9 WRMF.
If you're the victim of a car crash, never rush to settle with the insurance companies and never settle for just any attorney. Demand Anna Jar and Levine. Call 1-800-747-FREE for a free consultation and take back control of your life.
In Office West Palm Beach.
Coconut shrimp is back at Pollo Tropical. We're serving a perfectly golden, sweet, and savory coconut shrimp in a bowl, platter, or as a side with our pineapple rum sauce. Don't miss out on coconut shrimp at Pollo Tropical. Try it today.
Want your child to go to summer camp, but afraid you can't afford it? Did you know you can apply for one of the more than 3,000 summer camp scholarships available right now for Palm Beach County children? Now is the time to apply for camp scholarships. The deadline is April 12th. To learn more, go to everyparentpbc.org/camp. That's everyparentpbc.org/camp. This message brought to you by Children's Services Council of Palm Beach County.
Business. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these companies is a partner helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all choose the Advanced Network, Cybersecurity Solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business, the company that powers more businesses than anyone else. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
See why Comcast Business powers more small businesses than anyone else. Get started with fast speeds and advanced security for $49 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add one unlimited mobile line. Plus, ask how to get up to an $800 prepaid card with a qualifying gig bundle. Don't wait. Call to switch today. Ends 5/5/24. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 100 megabits per second internet and security edge. Eco bill and auto pay required. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra.
If you're thinking about relocating, now is the time to call Good Greek. Maybe you're thinking about moving. They can help you with your real estate. Maybe you're thinking about moving all your stuff and then storing it. They can help you with that too. They can also help with insurance and a mortgage. The team at Good Greek does it all. And for you, it's one-stop shopping, eliminating the need to go around to 5 different vendors.
You notice that places that do things right, they grow. They get bigger. That's why Good Greek is growing the way they are, because they do it right. And that means taking care of you, taking care of your stuff, and giving you great customer service.
The side of my house right now definitely needs Good Greek over there.
Yeah, all you need to do is call them because they can do anything. They can lift from the smallest stuff to the biggest stuff and everything in between. They'll do you right with the customer service and take all the stress out of your relocation. Go to goodgreek.com because it's all Good Greek to us.
Hi, it's Randy, and my Easter tradition is with the Honey Baked Ham Company.
Because there's nothing like it. And look, you got to shop early and avoid the rush. Honey Baked's complete Easter meals are impressive, delicious, but they're convenient. That's my favorite part. Spend less time in the kitchen, more time with family. Complete meals, bone-in, boneless ham, smoked and roasted turkey breasts, the side dishes are available for any size gathering. And those heat and serve sides are just super convenient. You can put them in the microwave or the oven. They're ready in as little as 15 minutes. If you're hosting brunch, not dinner this year, did you know that Honey Baked's take and bake sliders and biscuits are amazing? Check this out. Ham and Swiss sliders, garlic herb turkey and cheddar sliders, and the ham and cheddar biscuits. I'm so hungry just thinking about it. And don't forget about dessert. Honey Baked has those decadent cakes and pies as well. And you got to get it at Honey Baked Ham. They got you covered for Easter brunch and dinner or any of your spring gatherings. The meals are delicious, easy to serve, and convenient. HoneyBaked.com. Place an order for pickup. Find a store near you and see the extended store hours. Walk-in customers are always welcome too. And happy Easter from Honey Baked Ham.
Where it happens, 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 where it happens,
Hamilton is coming. Get tickets today for the Tony, Olivier, Grammy, and Pulitzer Prize winning musical. It's the story of America then, told by America. Now, Hamilton in West Palm Beach at the Kravis Center from April 10th to 21st. Get tickets at Kravis.org.
At Target, our prices for Easter are so low, you can put all your eggs in one basket. Surprise them with Target-exclusive Favorite Day treats, like our unique chocolate bunny and a cute basket, all from just $4. Add in some fun with a six-pack of bubbles, 50-piece sidewalk chalk, and super soft stuffed animals, all from $5. And get great family pics with new Easter looks. It's easy with women's and girls' dresses for only $20 and under. Low prices on everything for Easter? Now that's Target.
When you wake up well-rested on a great mattress, everything becomes clear.
Wow, I'm a morning person.
Things you missed when you were tired finally reveal themselves.
I should not use a chatbot to write my wedding vows.
This is your official invite to Mattress Firm's Friends and Family Sale. Save up to $700 with the Friends and Family discount. Plus, get a free adjustable base with select Sealy mattresses. See a lower price? We'll match it. The right mattress matters. We'll find yours. Restrictions apply. See store website for details.
Racetrack coffee is beaned a cup. The fresh ground taste is gonna pick you up. Different choices with lots of flavor.
Yeah, that tracks. Customize your blend, creamers, and toppings to make your coffee a guaranteed hit.
You're making your cup the way you know it should. Racetrack coffee, it's crazy good.
Racetrack, whatever gets you going.
Now back to more of the KVJ replay. Only on 97.9 WRMF.
Well, Jaybird is a child of the 1980s. You just go into his house and you look around and it's pretty much 1984.
It's 80s and 90s, and I'm trying to morph into some 70s stuff, but man, 70s stuff is kind of expensive.
You could charge a ticket price at the door for people to walk through. It is a museum.
No, so much to do still. So much more to do. I've got so many more ideas. The ceiling hasn't even been utilized the way it needs to be.
You've lost your mind.
I, you know what? And it feels free. Yeah. I love it.
We got to turn this thing into a money-making venture. We're bleeding out, Jaybird. You spend so much.
Okay, well, let's see if Jaybird can get these 80s catchphrases right, meaning you have to name the show or the source of this catchphrase.
How many do you have?
How many do you want, Virginia? I could do 10 here.
My boy goes 10 for 10.
10 for
That's
10.
Absolutely so wrong.
Whatever.
I don't know everything from the 80s.
Yes, you do.
I almost like you when you don't believe in me.
It goes better.
It feels more natural.
It's crawfish week, bruh. Women supporting women. Come on. Let's go, Cupcake.
All right. Okay, let's see. What is this 80s catchphrase from, Bird?
But I pity the fool.
Oh, that's from the A-Team, Mr. T.
There you go. Very nice.
Okay.
All right. He's rolling me up. He always starts off with a softball.
He wants to get you into a lull of fake confidence.
I think that Kevin Rawson wants me to go 10 for 10 on this one.
Okay.
What? Kevin does. Riggy does not.
No, come on. I'm pulling for you here, Bird. Okay, what about this 80s catchphrase?
Who'd you talking about, Willis?
I mean, it's Arnold Drummond, Different Strokes.
Okay.
His dad was Philip Drummond.
Uh-huh, look at this guy, okay.
Rest in peace. Off now.
Rest in peace, and I personally think Gary Coleman was
murdered.
Oh, what?
Yep. He was married to this scandalous woman.
Just look into the Gary Coleman murder. That's all I'm saying.
Look into their marriage and their relationship. He was pushed down the stairs. You know what happens a lot on Dateline?
Push down the stairs. Okay.
I'm trying to make sure he's still listening because I know he checks out when I'm talking.
What are you talking about?
I got to quiz him.
What are you talking about, Willis?
What are you talking about, Virginia?
I got to try to keep him involved.
What are you talking about, Witchy?
Okay, what is the source of this 80s catchphrase, Bird?
Go, go, Gadget Legs!
That's Inspector Gadget.
That is okay. Inspector Gadget. Very nice.
Inspector Gadget.
Used to love that show.
I had the doll. And that doll, if you want to get it fully loaded with everything in it from the 80s, it's not that cheap.
Okay.
You have to pay.
You have it.
I do not have an
inspector. Oh, you do not have it.
I don't have an Inspector Gadget. They had a whole Inspector Gadget line that is pretty... All right.
Go, Gadget, go.
What was the name of the girl on Inspector Gadget?
I can't remember.
Oh, Virginia. Do you remember?
Melanie?
Penny. Yeah.
Penny.
I didn't watch Inspector Gadget a lot.
You didn't? Okay.
Oh, I did.
I had the doll, though.
I loved Inspector Gadget.
Okay, what about this one? What is the source of this 80s catchphrase?
I know you are, but what am I?
That's Pee Wee Herman.
That is Pee Wee Herman, yeah.
Okay.
I know you are, but what am I?
I know you are, but what am I?
Oh, man, I was just in stitches when I saw him with that one big top Pee Wee movie. He had a hot dog tree. That's good comedy.
Yep. Hot dog tree's awesome.
All right, perfect so far. What about this one, Jay Bird?
Where's the beef?
That's Where's the Beef is a Wendy's ad. Where's the Beef is Wendy's.
It is Wendy's, yeah.
Yay! Okay. You can't miss a fast food one.
No. I was getting her mixed up with Herb. I don't think you guys remember Herb from Burger King. I brought it up last time, and it did not go well. No one knew what I was talking about.
So, yeah, bring it up again.
That's kind of what I do.
What you talking about?
What you talking about, Willis?
Okay, what about this one? What's the sort of this 80s catchphrase?
Don't be ridiculous.
Don't be ridiculous. That's Balky from Perfect Strangers.
Do you remember his last name?
Balky, no.
Bataka Moose.
There we go. Give you credit, though.
Yeah, I'll give you credit. You got Balky.
And the show's name.
Yeah, no, that was pretty good. Yeah, you get credit, Bird. Okay, what about this old school show? I'm going to take you back. In fact, I think this is early 80s, maybe even late 70s.
Uh-oh. Oh, boy.
Here's where I crapped the bed.
Okay. Will Berg go perfect? What is this catchphrase from?
Nanu, nanu.
Nanu, nanu is from Mork and Mindy.
It is.
Wow.
Yeah, Robin Williams. Very nice.
I had that figure, too. You could buy that figure of Mork, a.k.a. Robin Williams, in an egg, and the egg would break open, and the figure would come out.
Ah,
you
can
buy that
okay.
in those little things where you put a quarter and what?
You just got so excited.
I know.
Did,
yeah.
But wait. Here's your Hank Pink, Mork Dork.
I am such a dork. I don't care. I lost my mind and I love it.
This catchphrase is from?
How rude.
That is Stephanie Tanner. That is Full House.
Yes, it is. Very nice.
Wow.
Okay, and to go perfect, you have to get this one correct, Bird. What is this from?
I've fallen, and I can't get up.
That's from an infomercial where the old lady falls. It's for the heart thing, where the heart pulse. You hit the button, the call alert.
What's it called?
Call alert or life alert?
Life alert. Yeah.
Life alert. Wow.
I've been having dreams, jumping on a trampoline. Flipping in the air, I never land, just float there. As I'm looking up, suddenly the sky erupts. Flames alert the trees, spread to fallen leaves. Now they're right upon me. Wait if I'm on fire. Been having dreams, splashing in the summer stream, tripping, I fall in. I wanted it to happen. My body turns to ice, crushing weight of paradise. Solid block of gold, lying in the cold. I feel right. Wait if I'm on fire. How am I so deep in love? When
Jaybird's a lot of interesting things in his house. If you've ever seen any of the TikTok videos, you definitely know. But when he does inventory, it's kind of interesting to hear just what products he has and how many. He's got a lot of unicorn pencils. I'll put the number at 24. Is the actual number over or under that amount, Virginia?
24 feels like a trick number.
You do good on this game, by the way. And you're going against Denny's. You better not know me better than Sweet Denny's.
Dog.
Keep telling me how good I do.
Yeah, that was a mistake.
I'm going to say more.
You're going to go over. What do you think, Denny's?
Over 24. He does have a lot of unicorn stuff.
He loves unicorns, huh?
Who does?
Well, I'm working on a unicorn, a whole cryptozoology section.
Okay.
And you got to throw unicorn in there. It deserves its place.
Okay. All right.
I'm just thinking about how many they sell. Packs of pencils, it's usually like 6, 12, 18, even if you bought 3 packs.
He's a man of packs.
He is.
He's a packs man.
I am.
I'm going to say less than.
You're going to go
different.
With less than? Virginia's right. He has 64 unicorn pencils. 64 of them.
And the reason why you buy them in bulk is, A, I got a good deal, and you don't want a pencil sharpener. You want to display them as a backdrop.
They're not for writing.
They're not for writing. They're for a backdrop.
Mm-hmm.
A little think piece.
Uh-huh.
Interesting.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking you're losing your mind.
So oh, I'm definitely losing my mind.
You need to get a girlfriend.
I would never bring this kind of crazy into her world.
He's protecting this unknown girl.
I'm protecting her. She doesn't deserve this.
What about fake plastic bonsai trees? Kind of like what was featured in the original Karate Kid.
Exactly like the Karate Kid.
Okay, I've seen these. These are these FAPs, fake-ass plants.
They are awesome, though.
Mm-hmm. He had them all in his room around the perimeter.
Lining his entire room.
Yes. Keeping it sexy.
I got so many compliments on them.
I'll put the number at 10. Denny's. What is the actual number, over or under that?
He's got to have more than 10. I mean, he used to line every room with them and outside.
Yeah.
He's got to have more than 10.
So many FAPs.
More than 10, okay.
He's got to have more than 10.
Okay, you're going to go over. What do you think, Virginia?
I agree with Big D.
Okay, going to go over on that.
Oh!
He's only got 7.
Yeah. A lot got lost in
the
move.
Are you sure you counted right?
You guys are getting them mixed up with my regular FAPs. These are just straight up bonsai.
Oh,
so only
straight
the
up
bonsai.
Specifically
yes.
Bonsai. Oh.
You got a lot of plants around the perimeter.
You tripped me up with your depth.
This game is designed. It's layered.
Damn it, Denny's. We blew it.
Okay, Jaybird's got a lot of Star Wars backpacks.
That was a tough one.
And then I go to fourth period.
Who's the girl you got a crush on?
Her name's Sally. I love her. I hope she loves me back.
I'll put the number at 11. What is the actual number that Jaybird has? Is it over or under 11, Virginia?
I'm feeling under on this one.
Okay.
It's a fine choice.
What do you think, Denny's?
I'm feeling over.
Okay.
Just because Star Wars, you have so much Star Wars decor, and you wear some. You have that Chewbacca one you wear, the one with Yoda.
You're wearing a baby Yoda sweatshirt as we speak.
Yeah.
Dang, it's cold in here.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to have to say over.
You're going to go over on that. Denny's, you have missed all of them so far.
Man.
It's 7. It's under.
Do you even know me, man?
I'm overestimating all these.
I'm the new Miho.
No,
yeah,
you are not.
The She-Ho. I don't know about that, actually.
She-Ho.
Not really a good name,
no,
but
She-Ho.
Kind of offensive.
We'll take it. We'll take it.
She-Ho.
Okay, what about radio station lanyards? I'll put the number at 15. Is the actual number over or under 15, Virginia?
And think about the weird events we've done.
So many weird events. so many lanyards. But I feel like you usually lose the lanyard at the event.
I say, how many do you keep of those as memorabilia?
It's all I'm in your heads. Yeah.
You are.
I'm in your head.
You're in there deep.
All right. I want out.
Nope, you're trapped. I'm going to go under.
Going to go under 15, Denny's?
I'm going to go over, only in the case that he kept them by accident. They're in a box and he just found a bunch.
Okay.
So I'm going to go on that.
Good choice.
That's okay. Exactly what happened. Denny's is so right. They were in a box from moving, and they are some crappy lanyards, not even from our fun events.
I keep only the bad ones.
Yeah, I do.
He's got 24 radio
24.
Station lanyards.
Look
I will
at
say
you.
There's a few duplicates in there.
Okay.
Okay, final one here. How many different types of canned frosting does Jaybird have at his house?
Currently,
right now. I'll put the number at 15.
Oh, my God.
15?
No way he's got 15. Canned
okay.
frosting?
Yeah, canned frosting.
Yeah, we're going to come over after
frosting.
The show. We're going to count.
I would love that, actually. That would be a frosting party, and I'm so here for it.
Yeah. Don't tease him with a good
yeah,
time.
Yeah, now we're having a frosting party.
Yeah.
15.
Yeah.
And they're open or unopened? Does it matter?
No, it doesn't. They could be
15.
Yeah.
Mixed bag.
Yeah, different states of.
Some are like pre-COVID, probably.
Mm-hmm.
I love hearing you guys work this
I can
out.
See them, but are there 15?
That's what I can see a fair amount, even in your wildest, which you ever buy 15 of those.
I'm a cake making she-ho, and I don't even have 15. I've got a lot of frosting at any given time.
We're talking about just cake frosting.
Yeah.
The little plastic.
Just
Duncan Hines, Pillsbury.
Yeah, stuff you put on a cake.
Pre-made frosting, which, by the way, at Publix right now, they're BOGO.
Publix got a lot of BOGO going on.
They got a BOGO on frosting. I was just there last night because today is Panda's birthday.
So did Bird buy BOGO? Is that why he's got so many?
Did he buy BOGO?
Could be.
Oh, gosh. Golly, we don't want to blow it, Kevin. We take this very serious.
That's right, Kevin.
All right, you're at 15. Over or under that amount, Denny's?
We take a 3-minute bit and make it 15.
I know. It's long.
Kevin's trying to get to birthdays.
It's an art form.
it's our thing. It's, you know.
Oh, apprehensively, I'm going to say less than 15. I just find that so many.
It's a lot. It's a lot of frosting.
Ugh, the tone, though, I hear. It sounds like.
What do you think, Virginia?
I mean, I guess I got to try to be different from Denny's. If he's going under, I'll go over, but not with confidence.
Okay, the actual number is 11. It is under Denny.
Wow.
Gets
look
the point,
at you.
And we get a tie.
Finish strong, Denny.
I can feel it.
Two apiece.
Written in these walls are the stories that I can't explain. Leave my heart open, but it stays right here empty for days. She told me in the morning she don't feel the same about us in her bones. Seems to me that when I die, these words will be written on my stone. And I'll be gone, gone tonight. The ground beneath my feet is open wide. The way that I've been holding on too tight, with nothing in between. The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm in time. It's frozen. The story of my life. Stays right here in its cage. And I'll be gone, gone tonight. Fire beneath my feet is burning bright. The way that I've been holding on so tight.
97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. We have a crash tying you up this morning in Broward County on 95 northbound. This one is right at Commercial Boulevard. Look for a left lane blocked in that area. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Injured? Visit Lytle Rider, Smith, Ivy, and Fronrath at foryourrights.com.
I'll tell you, there's never been a better time to upgrade to a new Kia. It's Nick Rivers. With inventory levels the best they've been in years, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach highly motivated to make some deals that other dealers won't. Drive home in a new 2024 Kia Forte for only $219 a month. 24-month lease with $2,799 due at signing. Plus, all new Kias come with a 10-year, 100,000-mile limited warranty. Are you unsure about your credit? Forget it. Get pre-qualified online without affecting your credit score at GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. Plus, hey, they want your old car. Bring in any trade. Get up to a $5,000 discount off any select new Kia stocks only at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS, follow them on Facebook or online, GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. And remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Qualified applicants through KMF, 10,000 miles per year, security deposit waived, plus tax. Tag and $9.99 admin fee. Negative equity refinance. Discount includes all factory rebates to dealer. Warranty is a limited powertrain warranty. See Kia.com or retailer for details. Offers don't combine. Expires May 5th.
Rapids Water Park. Mega thrills. Mega fun. And coming later this spring, new Mega Mayhem. The first dueling water coaster in Florida. Visit now for spring break and come back for Mega Mayhem with a season pass. Save 45% and get a free souvenir cup now through April 3rd. Only at South Florida's Mega Thrill Capital, Rapids Water Park. It's Mega 2024.
Man, I'm telling you, the difference it makes when you switch out your windows and doors. I did it, and it took me 3 years to do it because I paid it off in phases. BNT will work with you, just like they worked with me. If you don't have all money up front, you can break it up into three phases like I did. And now, bam, here I am. Last year was my first hurricane season with my house completely fortified courtesy of BNT windows and doors. Every window, every door, hurricane ready. It just gave me a sense of peace I had never had before. I gotta tell you, it was kind of nice to be like, well, I've done everything I can to fortify this home. Whatever happens, happens. It did give me peace. You want that peace too. Get it for yourself. Call BNT. You know, they use custom PGT products, and PGT makes the best-selling window and door on the market. Go online today. BNT Windows and Doors.
A true partner in your health dedicates time to understanding your needs,
At Conviva Care Center, doctors make one-on-one time with you a priority, so you can get all your questions answered and feel more confident in your healthcare. Conviva Senior Care Experts have been helping seniors stay healthy and independent for more than 50 years. Schedule a tour today at tourconviva.com. That's tourconviva.com.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
It's mainly clear skies this morning, some patchy fog. Inland temperatures are mild in the low to mid-70s. Kick off our Monday, then heating up to high of 90 this afternoon before a few thunderstorms arrive late in the afternoon and evening. A few of those storms could be strong. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by WeBuyAnyCar.com. Before you sell or trade in, find out how much your car is worth at WeBuyAnyCar.com. They make selling your car fast, safe, and fair. Get your free online valuation now at WeBuyAnyCar.com.
They keep it real. The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Let me like.
KVJ replay continues right now, only on 97.9 WRMF.
The average bad date will last 51 minutes before somebody throws out an excuse. It's almost like a penalty flag in football, and like, I got to bounce, got to go. So how long is it for you on average, and what was the moment when you realized you needed to go, and then what kind of excuse or escape plan? Did you come up with something lame or just say, that's gross, I gotta bounce?
Or were you like Jay Bird and you just got lucky and the cops intervened and took your girl away in handcuffs?
So nice, yeah.
I mean, you really didn't have to do anything. You just sit back, enjoy the show, and the cops finish it for you.
And then I walked back to my apartment going, what the hell just happened?
Jenna said, I was with a guy, went through the whole date, about 90 minutes, and what did it for me? He started eating crumbs off the table. He would, like, wipe them off, and then he would throw them into his mouth.
Yeah, my buddy said he went on a date with this, he was with this girl, and they were eating, and she ordered corn, and I guess she got corn stuck in her teeth, so she goes in her purse and brings out a business card and starts picking the corn of her teeth with the business card at the table. He couldn't believe it. He really couldn't believe it.
Was she just trying to get a free meal?
Virginia, I wasn't there.
She might be doing, like, how to lose a guy in 10 days on him. Just purposely trying to be awful.
If I remember, I still think she hit him up after.
Really?
Yeah, man. It was bizarre.
She wanted more corn.
How gnarly is that?
Did he buy her corn?
I can't remember.
He probably paid for the meal, and she probably was like, all right, this is how I'm going to get free corn.
It was a date. It was a real date, yeah. And he said he just was shocked at what happened.
We got a text here. It says, my best friend called me from a restaurant bathroom to come pick her up real quick when her date brought his ex-girlfriend with him.
What?
Yeah, it's a pretty good reason to end a date.
On the date?
Yeah.
What kind of weird game are they playing?
That's odd, man. That's really odd.
It happens, y'all.
Bunch of drinking ones as well. Somebody said, I got a rule of never doing dinner on the first day, only drinks. I had a date a few years ago, and we both knew immediately we weren't into each other. And when the bartender asked if we wanted a second round, we're both like, nope.
We're good. Yep.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's cool if you both can say that and be cool. I don't like you. You don't like me.
Yeah, if you have any kind of doubts that it's not going to be good, you should do coffee because that's even quicker than drinks. Say, look, I'll meet you at Dunkin'. We'll get a little coffee action. That's 20 minutes.
I do love the fact that you plugged Dunkin', but I think coffee dates are weird, man.
Yeah.
A day coffee date is odd to me.
Not if you drink coffee. Most people drink coffee and they're like, yeah, okay, that's cool. And you're letting them know, I'm not here to make some big commitment to something that's not going to work out.
Is there any difference between meeting somebody at a Starbucks or a brewery?
Yes, there is a difference.
Uh-huh.
Because one's alcohol. And
you might have multiples at a brewery.
Yeah, look, you get a buzz.
You're not going to drink multiple coffees?
I don't want, if I'm not sure that I'm going to like him, I don't want to have beers with him. Because then the beers might trick me into thinking I like him.
I don't know. You keep drinking multiple coffee, and it does, you guys do hit off. A, now you've got bad coffee breath, and you're probably going to crap yourself. Right? It's a diuretic, no?
Do you poop yourself off in Virginia after drinking coffee?
No.
Okay.
I've heard some horror stories.
I have butt control. Apparently, my buddy over here to the left is not.
I have the best BC.
I gotta tell you, if I drank coffee and I pooped my pants, it'd be my last cup of coffee. That's when I realized, yeah.
That is some vicious coffee.
I'm gonna stay away from that liquid.
Hey, don't paint me with that brush. I've got fantastic BC.
Okay.
Prove it.
One text said, I met somebody at Funky Buddha for our first date. He showed up late, stumbled in, admitted to taking Percocet and having four beers before he came.
Oh, my gosh. We don't even need to finish talking. We're done.
Yeah, he was loud, obnoxious. I hadn't even finished my first beer. And I'm like, look, I'm not feeling this. And I just left. He called and texted me dozens of times that night, called me all sorts of names.
Oh, my gosh. What a nightmare.
Dodged a bullet.
Yeah. No, that's tough. And I will tell you, though, just hearing what my daughter does, you know, a lot of times she'll pregame before a date, and I know
I don't like that. I love drinking. Nobody is a bigger proponent than me of getting a buzz on, but I don't want them to be intoxicated, and I don't want to be intoxicated. I want to see what they're about.
Right.
They got a 20-minute window to either impress me or not, and then I want out.
I think you're so right. You don't want to do. You don't want. I mean, a drink maybe to take the nerves down a little bit.
I don't want that.
I'm just saying, but to your point, getting too tipsy is not the right move before a date.
I agree. I was like, I don't know. I get it.
It's about nervousness.
Yeah,
and for that
is.
Reason, I do get it.
Yeah.
But you do yourself a disservice when you're not in clear mind and they're not in clear mind. And if it's really somebody you want to date, you need to look at it and do it in clear mind. If not,
yep.
You're doing this on purpose and you're self-sabotaging your relationships, which is a deeper problem there.
That's true.
Coffee day dates.
Nah, Bert ain't feeling it.
Poopy Pennington doesn't like that coffee date.
What's wrong with me? Why do I feel like this?
In case you missed it, the KVJ replay is on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. We have a crash tying you up currently in Broward County. This one is on 95 southbound, and it's right at the exit for Oakland Park Boulevard. Look for two left lanes blocked in that area. That's traffic. I'm Suits from 97.9 WRMF.
You call that a precision stop?
When a rookie stunt driver,
just give me a shot,
meets the trainer who thought he'd seen it all.
Come on, focus.
They'll soon find out that behind the wheel of the Nissan Rogue, with the power of VC Turbo and the most fuel-efficient gas-powered engine in its class,
watch this,
the protege can become a master. But this is no ordinary blockbuster. It's a Nissan sales event ad.
Level up your drive with 1.9% APR financing for 60 months on the 2023 Nissan Rogue. Shop the Nissan sales event. Visit your local Nissan store and NissanUSA.com today. Auto Pacific segmentation excluding hybrids and electric vehicles. 2024 APA fuel economy estimates from 28 City 34 Highway to 30 City 37 Highway for 2024 Nissan Rogue. Actual mileage may vary. For well-qualified buyers, 1.9% APR financing for 60 months on new 2023 Rogue and dealer stock. Example, 60 months financing at $1,748 per month per 1,000 financed. Actual down payment may vary. Subject to residency restrictions and NMAC credit approval. Not all buyers qualify. Dealer contribution may affect actual price set by dealer. Contact dealer for details. Ends 4/1/24.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
Every March, Jersey Mike's turns money from subs into charitable donations.
And March 27th is Jersey Mike's annual day of giving, where 100% of sales from every sub are given back to the community.
And to kick off all that giving, Peter gave me an apron. I'm honored.
Looking good, Danny. We've got subs to make, though.
Yeah. Now I know why you gave me the apron.
Join us Wednesday, March 27th for Jersey Mike's Day of Giving. Be a sub above.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach. Portions of the following program have been pre-recorded.
All righty, neither option is necessarily good, but you've got to choose one. Would you rather? Two of the more uncomfortable things for the human body to do, and that is either the hiccups or feeling like you have to sneeze. So, what would you rather have, hiccups for the rest of your life or constantly feel like you've got to sneeze, Virginia?
I guess hiccups, because with the whole sneezing thing, there comes boogies and allergies and snot, and I don't want to deal with that. I guess hiccups I can more contain.
Okay. Yeah, people will probably look at you like you're less gross with the hiccups than if you're sneezing. If you're sneezing, boy, people will be like, ugh. And especially remember during COVID, if you ever sneezed or coughed,
oh my gosh,
people would take
you
off
ain't
sprinting
kidding.
Away from you.
I coughed one time in Denny's room, and Virginia sprinted out of the studio. Why are you coughing? She's like, oh my gosh, I didn't mean it. I'm sorry. I drank water and it choked me out.
I looked at people in the grocery store like, how dare you?
Right. Yeah, exactly. What about you, Bird? Which one are you going to choose? Hiccups for the rest of your life or constantly feeling like you've got to sneeze?
I had hiccups one time for about 3 hours and I started getting scared that I was going to be that like that one girl who had it for 9 years. Remember that one?
Yeah.
She had hiccups forever.
How horrifying is that?
It was awful. Hiccups are rough. But when you don't get that satisfaction of that sneeze when it's coming, I think I got to take hiccups.
They both hiccups. Sound terrible.
They're both awful.
Okay. Would you rather be surrounded by people who brag all the time or by people who complain all the time? Which one of these two is worse?
Brag is better than complain. Complain is negativity. I can't.
It sucks the life out of you.
It does.
It does. It's a soul sucker.
Okay. What about this? Would you rather be ugly but smell amazing or be hot but stink?
Hot but stink.
Yeah, hot but stink.
Yeah, because we kind of heard that about Brad Pitt, but it really didn't deter his sex symbol status.
But what kind of stink are we talking about? I mean, if you're going to be hot, it's got to be a horrible smell.
I heard BO, and BO, I think, is easier to deal with than a farty smell, right?
Yeah, but if you're hot with a farty smell, I think that's different than it's hot tougher. Being with BO.
Yeah.
So what's the smell?
If Brad Pitt was as hot as he is but smelled like farts.
I don't think, I think his hot factor goes way down.
Okay. So the BO we can take because it's almost like an animal magnetism.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. He's gone on record saying he likes his girls a little stinky.
It's a lot harder to be hot than it is, you know, to worry about your smell. I mean, it's easy to smell amazing, I would think. So it's much better to be hot but stink.
Right.
Okay, what about this? Would you rather fight Mike Tyson one time in his prime or for eternity have the voice of Mike Tyson as your internal monologue? What do you think?
Oh, my gosh.
Iron Mike, 19-year-old. He likes to just destroy people.
I think I got to take him as the monologue because I could not take a punch from Mike Tyson.
I go monologue. I don't even know if I hear a voice in my head when I talk to myself.
You will now.
Yeah, I think you just get used to it eventually.
Anything that you think, any of your thoughts, will be narrated in that voice.
And so instead of your voice, it'll be Mike's voice.
Yeah. And you sandwich. I mean, I'm hungry.
You both have a lisp.
Dang. Wow, that's cold. Hit me with my shortcomings, flaws.
Oh, man.
I had to be in speech class.
So you're just saying it's a wash, Virginia.
It's a wash.
You're trading one for the other. Oh, jeez.
I will.
That's cold.
I'll take the inner monologue. She's right. I already have a lisp.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, I think you're irreparably changed if you face off against the old Iron Mike.
You might die.
Yeah.
I was watching some videos with my brother the other day of him in his prime, especially when he was just murdering people.
He was knocking people out in 10 seconds. They were coming into the ring and he was like, and they were just down. And it was like, all right, fight's over. Hardly any of his fights went to a second round.
I forget what fight. I think it was the Spinks fight. They show Spinks before the fight starts. He looks legit afraid, scared, alone.
He was just an animal. I mean, I don't know all the boxing history. Muhammad Ali, for instance, was really before my prime, but I don't know if anybody struck fear in the hearts of other fighters like Mike Tyson.
I don't remember Ali biting one's ear off either.
It's true. That's a finishing move right there. And then turning it into a business with the guy whose ear you bit off.
Yeah. Pretty impressive. That's crazy.
Okay, would you rather have someone spoil every movie before you see it or have every song you've ever loved just be a little too loud to enjoy?
Spoil the music or spoil the movie for me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that would be rough. Just you love the song, you're like, yeah, but it's a little, can you just turn it down just a little bit?
Which can happen.
Yeah. And they can't do that. Okay, would you rather every morning when you get out of bed immediately step barefoot on a Lego or stub your pinky toe?
Lego. I got real strong feet.
Yeah, I'm going to step on a Lego, too. Stubbing your toe hurts
that really,
so bad.
Yeah, it does. It does.
I got strong soles of the feet, very weak toes, though.
He walks on the linoleum, and it sounds like he's tap dancing.
She's here all day, guys.
Yeah. She goes after the list, your feet. I mean, you know, come on.
Go after Kevin a little bit.
Yeah.
Jeez.
You really got it hard, that
at
segment.
Least spread it out.
Yeah. Good heavens.
I made for
Everybody's in the emoji game. I know when my dad is in the emoji game that everybody's in the emoji game. He loves emojis now. He's all over it. And I think, like anybody, he seems to have his favorites. But I do kind of notice that there is a style to it. And I think you could look at anybody's emoji game and probably guess their age just by the emojis they use. I remember my daughter Caitlin, for a while when she was a teenager, she would go into our phone book and all of our contacts are in one place. I knew every one of her friends because there wasn't any names. It was just a series of about 20 emojis. I'm like, I don't know how you know who any of these people are.
Two hearts and a little bear and a leaf.
Right. There's all kinds of whack, crazy emojis, and there was like 30 of them. It seemed like it was completely unnecessary, but it's a language all unto itself. See, I'm kind of in that middle level, so maybe I'm not as basic as my dad, but I'm definitely not as venturous as my kids. So where is your emoji game? They're saying that there are 10 emojis you can use that will make you look old. So if you use these, the young kids know they got a boomer on the other end.
Okay.
Even if they don't know who they're talking to, thumbs up was number one.
Oh.
And my dad loves the thumbs up. It's just quick to be like, because a lot of times I think younger people, they just stop texting, and that's okay. Full stop, baby. You know, they don't mind. They just move on about their day. My dad's always got to give you that. Okay, I got the message. Thumbs up.
I love a thumbs up. It's very inclusive of a bunch of different things. Like, yes, got it. I'm on it.
Right.
I can do it.
I like it.
I know what you're throwing down.
It's an affirmation.
It's an affirmation.
I sent my dad a lengthy, detailed text, and he goes, thumbs up.
Yeah.
He loves the thumbs
it's
up.
One of the things that drives me a little bit crazy about the youth, I especially notice with my 14-year-old son, Cannon, it seems like things just stop. And I'm like, okay, I just need to make sure and see in your eyes that you understand what was communicated. Because later you're like, hey, did you plug my phone in? Because I didn't wake up till 90 minutes late. And it's like,
you got no thumbs up. You actually got a thumbs down.
Actually, I did get the thumbs up. And then you're right. Then I woke up with the thumbs down. So...
So, how cold.
Well, that's why, to me, I like that affirmation of, all right, we got this. We're on the same page. We register. Thumbs up does that. But apparently that's just too formal and too boomer. That's the number one sign. The red love heart. Sent one of those to my daughter yesterday. That's the second way they know you're old. So she's like, dad's so old.
Oh, my gosh.
But it loves me.
I use that so much.
The red love heart is old?
That's what they say. 22% of younger people using emojis. That was the second most popular old person emoji.
So what do you go with, purple? I thought that meant something else.
I don't even know what things mean anymore.
I don't either. I thought purple meant...
I have no clue.
Trying to get a little frisky.
Well, that's a little purple devil.
I thought that. I just thought the whole color, if it purple heart, I don't know. Okay.
Right.
I'm old. No, I'm old. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't want to send that kind of message to my daughter. Yeah, dad.
Dad, why did you send me the purple devil?
Yeah.
Stop being weird.
That's one of the reasons why I do kind of stay in my emoji safe zone. I may look old, but at least I know what these things mean.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up. Okay hand was number three. Then you had tick. I don't even know what that is.
Tick.
It just says tick. T-I-C-K.
See, we're so old, we don't even know what that is.
Are we old because we don't even know it?
I don't even know what that is.
Oh, what does tick mean?
The poo emoji is number five.
My dad thought it was chocolate.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, that's sweet.
He thought, hey, you want to go get ice cream? And he puts the poo emoji. The loudly crying face is the sixth emoji that the young ones say make you look old. And I use it all the time.
I've seen a lot of old people use it. They'll make a joke and they'll do three of those.
I do that. That's my old move all the time. I give you three to let you know just how much I'm laughing. And I would do the whole, what is it, the skull face, I'm dead. But I'm like, does everybody know that? And if I sent that to my dad would be like, oh my gosh, I think Kevin's in trouble.
Yeah.
You know, and who knows?
I knew things were getting weird out there when Kevin Ralston started sending emojis. I go, okay. I got to start doing emojis.
That'll let you know just how much old people are into the emoji game. When I'm using them, and then weeks later, my dad's using them. So now everybody's using emojis, but now you can really let people know, are you in the cool emoji game or not? These are the ones that make you look like you're not, I guess.
People started getting weird. We had a guy in our friend group that would send a smiley face after, you know, he'd send a text message and some guys would go, why is he sending smiley faces?
He's creepy.
But now everyone does it seems. I don't think he's creepy anymore.
I guess everything changes. Some of the other ones that make you look old, the monkey eye cover, the clapping hands, the lipstick kiss mark, and the grimacing face are the top 10 emojis that make you look old. So
the heart one is the one.
Heart hurts.
Red heart is old.
Red love heart is number two.
I'm pushing back on that one.
Yeah. Okay, because you're old.
Get off my lawn, kids.
So is there an alternate for this? Now, I do know the loudly crying face. Now you just send the skull, I'm dead.
Dead.
I'm just dead. I'm dead. I can't
I'm
even
dying
laugh
from
anymore.
Laughing.
I'm dying from laughing. I'm just already dead.
Just dead.
Just dead.
Capital letter.
I'm just dead. So what do you do if you want to acknowledge, yeah, I got your message and I'm on it? If you can't use thumbs up anymore without looking old.
Well, the dead one's probably on the verge of being old as well because...
Probably because we're talking about it.
I'm starting to see old people use that.
Just send the eggplant. That's what that means.
That's what that means.
Is that considered old? That one still seems to be universal.
Eggplant?
The eggplant.
I don't know. Eggplant purple devil face?
I don't know. You're right. That's so 2017, Bird.
Yeah, I don't know.
All the times that you rain on my parade. And all the clubs you get in using my name. You think you broke my heart, oh girl, for goodness sake. You think I'm crying on my own, well I ain't. And I didn't want to write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care or don't. But you still hit my phone up, and baby I'll be moving on. And I think it should be something I don't wanna hold back. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. And I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, but now I know I'm better sleeping on my own. Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. When you told me that you hated my friends, the only problem was with you and not them. And every time you told me my opinion was wrong, and tried to make me forget where I came from. And I didn't want to write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care or don't. But you still hit my phone up, and baby, I'll be moving on. And I think it should be something I don't wanna hold back. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. And I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, but now I know I'm better sleeping on my own. Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself.
For all the times that you made me feel small, I fell in love, now I feel nothing at all. I never felt so low when I was vulnerable. Was I a fool to let you break down my walls? Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself.
It's not a repeat, it's a replay. The KVJ replay on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. We have a crash tying you up currently in Broward County. This one is on 95 southbound, and it's right at the exit for Oakland Park Boulevard. Look for two left lanes blocked in that area. That's traffic. I'm Suits from 97.9 WRMF.
I'll tell you, there's never been a better time to upgrade to a new Kia. It's Nick Rivers. With inventory levels the best they've been in years, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach highly motivated to make some deals that other dealers won't. Drive home in a new 2024 Kia Forte for only $219 a month. 24-month lease with $2,799 due at signing. Plus, all new Kias come with a 10-year, 100,000-mile limited warranty. Are you unsure about your credit? Forget it. Get pre-qualified online without affecting your credit score at GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. Plus, hey, they want your old car. Bring in any trade. Get up to a $5,000 discount off any select new Kia stocks only at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS, follow them on Facebook or online, GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. And remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Qualified applicants through KMF, 10,000 miles per year, security deposit waived, plus tax. Tag and $9.99 admin fee. Negative equity refinance. Discount includes all factory rebates to dealer. Warranty is a limited powertrain warranty. See Kia.com or retailer for details. Offers don't combine. Expires May 5th.
You're going to love the team at the Aqua Plastic Surgery Center. It doesn't matter what on your body is stressing you out. Maybe you had kids. Maybe your breasts, it's ready to explant. Maybe you feel like you've lost a bunch of weight and your skin doesn't look right. Well, the Aqua Plastic Surgery Center, they specialize in everything body. Dr. Rankin runs the show, but everybody's on the same page. They want you to feel your best, your beach body best. Go to the boat with confidence. Go to the pool with confidence. Go to the beach with confidence, courtesy of Aqua Plastic Surgery. And Dr. Rankin, Dr. Bauermeister, and the female plastic surgeon, Dr. Giselle. Beach time will be here before we know it. And if anything physically is holding you back, this team can help with any body stuff. And they listen and they care. They just want you to be happy in your bikini or your bathing suit or whatever you're comfortable in. They listen and they care. In Jupiter and in Boca, go to aquaplasticsurgery.com.
Hey, West Palm Beach, looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on unlimited welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
Berry Fresh Cafe. It is lunch. It is brunch. It is all day lunch and brunch. Full liquor bar, beer, wine. We love all that. I love the mimosa flights that you can grab. The Bloody Mary flights made with bacon-infused vodka if you want. Oh, my gosh. And they're all over now in Stewart, in Jupiter, in Port St. Lucie, and the brand new location right there at US 1 and PGA in Palm Beach Gardens. Delicious. They've got a full menu of farm-to-table, locally sourced items. I love that. It's a scratch kitchen, which I also love. And they've got something for everybody. Keto, vegan, vegetarian, fresh pressed juices, and bacon infused vodka. It's family owned and operated. You're going to love it. Go check them out. Berry Fresh Cafe. Eat fresh, eat local, and be well at Berry Fresh Cafe.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
It's mainly clear skies this morning, some patchy fog. Inland temperatures are mild in the low to mid-70s. Kick off our Monday, then heating up to high of 90 this afternoon before a few thunderstorms arrive late in the afternoon and evening. A few of those storms could be strong. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Fuse Specialty Appliance.
The Fuse Specialty Appliance's spring clearance sale event is Saturday, March 23rd at the Deerfield Warehouse just off 95 and Hillsborough Boulevard. Up to 70% off premium appliances. Shop online now for the same incredible discounts. Visit FuseSpecialtyAppliances.com for more information.
Time for a Dunkin' Run, the official coffee of 97.9 WRMF.
Now, back to more of the KVJ Replay. Only on 97.9 WRMF.
We've been lied to pretty much our whole lives. And then you find out later on in life, you're like, wait a minute, I didn't know that. How old am I? And I just found out that I've been putting bat poop on my face. I mean, what the heck is going on here?
I'm 49. I had no idea that bat poop is the main ingredient in mascara.
I don't know about main, but it is an ingredient. Guana, I believe, is what it is called on the label. If you see that, that means bat poo.
Damn it, Kevin.
And that's one of the things you put on your face.
He ruined McDonald's ice or restaurant ice or gas station ice or every ice, and now you've ruined mascara.
I'm not kidding you. I've never looked at ice ever the same.
Yeah. You ordered a drink yesterday at the drive-thru. No ice.
You did that story 13 or 14 years
ago.
Right,
yeah. If I had a show, it would be Kevin Ruins Everything.
That's a funny name for a show.
Yeah, that'd just be it. That's what we should name the show.
I love mascara so much, Kevin.
Yeah, I know. Well, there's going to be a lot of things here that probably as a kid you heard growing up, and then you look like such an idiot later on in life when you're defending this thing, like at a bar or just with some friends, and they go, no, I swear this is the case. And they're like, no, and they look it up, quick Google search, and it shows that you're an idiot, and you were dying on that hill.
I got into a debate with a Snack Pack member because they were saying it was a myth, that whole eat food and you can't swim for 35. They go, that's not real. That's not a real thing. I think that is real.
Yeah. That's one of those kind of like myths.
I've done it where I've eaten and swam and I didn't cramp.
I've never gotten a cramp one time in my life after eating and getting right in there to swim. They've always told you, do not get in there and swim after you've eaten. What?
Well, my pool's not that deep, first of all. I can just stand up and be fine.
Yeah, I can go in the I can wade in the ocean.
Yeah. They say that it pretty much is a myth, the eating and swimming correlation. Yeah.
Look at this.
Yeah. So they said 30 minutes after eating, getting back in the pool. But apparently it's not a big deal.
I like to fly closer to the sun. I like to eat while I'm swimming.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They say that your biggest danger is probably a minor cramp. That would be it.
What a weird thing to harp on. Yeah. You might get a minor cramp, don't get in the water.
Mm-hmm. Well, I remember the one thing that I used to always hear when I was a kid. They would have a lot of TV sets would be lower to the ground, floor set TVs, and they'd always say, you sit too close, you'll go blind.
I'm like, where's this? Where are all these blind children that sat too close to the TV?
They said the same thing about exploring yourself too long.
That's always been a thing.
Well, if you can see, they all can see.
Yeah. I'm here to tell you,
Eagle Eye Pennington over here.
It's a myth.
And improved it.
Tugmaster of
his vision.
Tugmaster of the 80s.
They also said you can't stare at your food in the microwave, and I did that a lot as a kid.
I'm still standing.
Yeah, look at you now.
Yeah.
Look at you now.
I'm doing great.
Yeah. Some of the myths that have been busted that you were brainwashed to believe as a kid, carrots give you better eyesight. No, not true.
What?
They say the myth started because the British needed an excuse for why they kept shooting down German planes during World War II. They didn't want the Germans to know that they had radar, so they said their troops all had great night vision from eating carrots.
Wow.
So carrots don't do anything for your eyesight. It's a lie.
Yeah.
Because... somebody tell me, beta carotene, carrots, it's good for your eyes. And I was like, oh, okay.
And maybe there is some stuff that helps, but probably not to wear. Oh, you're never going to have to wear glasses if you eat carrots.
I got duped.
Yeah. Finding out that breakfast is the most important meal of the day, very debatable. In fact, the more research they do, they're like, no, it doesn't really matter. Calories are calories. It started because Kellogg's came up with a slogan more than 100 years ago, and it wasn't really based on science trying to tell you that breakfast was the most important meal of the day.
I would make the argument, because I don't eat during the weekday. I used to do it when I first got on the show. Mm-hmm. I can't do it. It bogs me down too much. I would argue eating a big old breakfast in the morning, you get nothing done. You want to lay. You're sluggish.
I can't do, if we have a live show or this show, if I eat before, I am like, brr.
Oh, there's nothing worse when you have to try to, and you have a big old full stomach. Mm-hmm. It sucks, man.
Yeah.
A pooch.
You gotta come here hungry.
You can't dance with a fupa.
It's you can, but it's tough.
Another thing you would hear when you were a kid, that we only use 10% of the brain. Not true. We actually use all of our brain, as different parts control different functions.
Oh, okay. That's good to know.
But I do feel like we haven't tapped in the proper way of using our brain.
It's possibly that you could extend.
I feel like you might not be using all of yours.
There's no need to be all sassy. I'm over here trying to have a smart conversation with Mr. Ralston.
Uh-huh.
I'm just saying, you see these savants get hit in the head with a piece of plywood, and all of a sudden they can play the piano.
That is a freak phenomena.
It just kind of shows me maybe we're not using it the proper way.
Or maybe if you hit it the proper way, you can become a savant.
I've been hitting it hard.
Or just an idiot.
it's a fine line, savant or idiot.
Idiot or savant. What are you going to be? Overly cracking your knuckles causes arthritis. That was the one thing they always used to tell us, but there's actually no science that backs this up whatsoever.
Some people can crack their knuckles and bones at an alarming level to where you go, ugh, are you okay?
I feel like too much cracking is not good.
That's because you've heard it.
It just doesn't feel right.
I love a good cracking.
I'm always cracking my fingers. In fact, it feels weird. I can tell when they need cracked, and I have to crack them.
You got that crack. You got the crack all on your back. Once you start doing it, you have to keep doing it.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
That's why I don't do it.
I like to do it. Sometimes I can accidentally make my ankles crack.
Yeah.
And it's
a relief.
It's
a relief.
Yeah,
it's releasing that fluid. That's kind of what makes the pop noise.
And we've learned from Denny's that ankle health is very important.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah.
He really does preach that a lot.
Yeah. And menstrual synchronicity. You were told that you and your friends could get on the same cycle time period just by hanging out with one another.
Me and Jay Bird are.
All three of us are. Kevin doesn't want to admit it.
Study after study debunks that. Say it's nothing but a myth.
I don't know.
It doesn't work.
We don't believe it. We crave things at the same time. We get moody at the same time.
We do. Kevin's on the same. He's on the same cycle.
Like it or not, you're on our cycle,
okay,
Kevin.
I'm with you, huh? Okay.
Let's go get some champs.
We all want to eat some chocolate together.
Let it rain. Let me talk to you. Come on. Shawty had the mouth out of jeans with the fur. The hoe club was looking at her. She hit the fur. She hit the fur. Next thing you know, Shawty got low. The baggy sweatpants and the Reeboks with the straps. a body to go. Them birthday cakes, they stole the show. So sectional, she was flexible, professional, drinking Xanol. Hold up, wait a minute, do I see what I think I will? Did a thing, I seen sure they get low. Ain't the same when it's up that close. Make it rain, I'm making it smooth. What the f***, I got the bang bro. I'ma say that I prefer them no clothes. I'm into that, I love women exposed. She threw it back at me, I gave her more. Cash ain't a problem, I know where it goes. She had them
watch a movie and you think to yourself, you know what, you really can't do that. Like, you would be arrested so quick if you ever tried anything like that.
Yes, all the time. It kind of sometimes bothers the movie for me.
Yeah, because it's so unrealistic. Like, there's no way you could be doing that. Like, you would get, you get life in prison for that.
There was that part in Taken, and I love Taken, and I get it, it's an action movie, but he causes that major, major car wreck on the road and then just walks away on the side of the street. Nobody sees this? Nobody's right, calling this in?
There is a bunch of things in movies that if you really broke it down, you would be doing time. It looks sweet in a movie, but if you actually tried to do this in reality, forget about it. You know, the one movie vehicle they always have where somebody dashes through airport security to declare their love as they're getting ready to get on the plane, and people are trying to get them, you can't go, and they're like, oh, but it's for love.
You do that post 9/11, you're going to get tased.
Oh, no doubt. Yeah. In fact, there was a dude at Newark International Airport that actually tried it. He saw it in movies like The Wedding Singer and The Thomas Crown Affair, and he said, no, people love this. It's a nice romantic gesture.
People love it.
Yeah, no. The terminal went into lockdown, and about 200 flights had to be delayed or canceled worldwide. Threw everything off.
Oh, dang.
Yeah, and now state legislature in New Jersey is hoping to pass a law calling for at least 18 months of imprisonment if you do this in the future. So you're looking at a year and a half in jail if you ever try to dash through airport security to go and profess your love for somebody.
Not so romantic anymore now, is it, Virginia?
No.
Nope. We talked about this just last week in a movie, Revenge of the Nerds, where you pull a little switcheroo and you wind up getting a little bit frisky with somebody when they think they're with another person and it's not. And then they're like, oh, but you were so good. I don't mind. What? That's not reality.
That is not reality.
No. It's happened in several movies, not just Revenge of the Nerds. It also was in the movie Overboard and While You Were Sleeping. Even the movie Only You had the same vehicle in it. If you do this in real life, though, you're looking at about 30 years in prison.
Well, Overboard because she didn't know her identity and he tricked her into thinking she was
the kid's mother.
The kid's mother. And
yes.
They fell in love, but it was all under false, you know,
mm-hmm.
facts there.
Dang, yeah. I never thought about it. That is shady.
Kurt Russell's character is a I know. They make her out to be the villain because mm-hmm. she was so rude and mean.
And he's teaching her a lesson.
Yep.
Oh, wow. It's such a good movie.
It's such a great movie.
Ugh, is it a good movie? Am I not allowed to like it anymore?
No, you can like it. Just don't tell anybody on the radio.
You remember the movie Wedding Crashers where she ties him up and then has her way with him? It's like, oh, okay, well, it's just a female doing this to a guy. What's the big deal, right?
Yes.
And in the end, he really did like it.
Oh, yeah.
And that's the way it works out in the movies. There's never a problem. You try that in real life, you're looking at least 6 months to life in prison, depending upon the circumstances and the jurisdiction.
Even the part in Wedding Crashers when the little brother with the weird painting comes in and gets on top of his body, doesn't let him go. That would be considered, that's a crime. You can't go into someone's room and hold them down.
Yeah, there's several things in the movie Wedding Crashers that if you did, you'd be looking at serious time. One of those is, remember the part where they doctor up his drink and they put the eye drops in there?
Oh.
They make him have the worst poopy cramps and throwing up.
You can't drug people.
Yeah. If you do that, you're looking at 2 to 10 years in prison and a possible attempted murder charge. There was a Florida woman that did that to a coworker and put the eye drops and was charged with poisoning, and the victim didn't even drink it.
Wow.
It turns out if you spike a drink with eye drops in the state of Florida, it can lead to dangerously low blood pressure, rectal bleeding, and a coma, and you're looking at some serious time, at least 2 to 10 years here in the state.
I don't think you have to consume it for you to go to jail, because it's kind of the same thing about if I wanted to kill Kevin and there's proof that I was going to kill you and they stopped
just because you fail and you're bad at what you're trying to do doesn't mean that you're not going to face any kind of repercussions. Yeah, that movie Wedding Crashers, man, is all over the place. Plus, also another one that happened there, the defending their honor with your fists, where you go and you fight somebody for their honor and you punch them. You know, if you do anything like that, you are looking at basically anywhere from a fine to several years in prison, depending upon their injuries and circumstances.
Wow.
So, Wedding Crashers are just full of things that if you try any of these things, you're going to go away for a long time.
Bad advice, Wedding Crashers.
I love that movie.
Right.
It's a great movie.
But it just goes to show you how unrealistic it is. They all should be in prison. And the other one, the Peeping Tom one, it's kind of cute in the movies, right? You're watching your true love interest from the bushes.
Me and Dennis were talking about what a creep McFly is from Back to the Future.
Yeah.
When you break it down, he was up in a tree.
In a tree.
Looking at his mom.
Yeah.
Get undressed.
Yep.
Well, I think it was his mom, right? Yeah.
Yeah. He had the binoculars.
He falls down. But what a great love story. He was a Peeping Tom prowler.
Yes, absolutely. And if you do that in real life, you can get up to 5 years in prison. And it wasn't just Back to the Future. They had it in Twilight Eclipse, Untamed Heart, Addicted to Love, that old romantic vehicle of spying on somebody from the bushes.
And I know the John Cusack thing wasn't illegal, but let's break it. It's kind of creepy, right?
Creepy, yes.
With the stereo on the lawn. Oh, it's so cute. If you're not feeling that, you're horrified someone's in your lawn with the boombox playing music.
And they're ugly.
Well, I'm not going in on the looks. I'm just saying, you're uneasy about it.
You don't think John Cusack's a good-looking man, Virginia?
Look, if he's hot, it's not creepy.
Chicks like John Cusack, I thought.
Yeah.
I thought he was a heartthrob,
he's
no?
He's okay.
He's cute, right? He's cutesy.
He's cutesy.
He's dorky cute.
Yeah. I know most people are like, who's John Cusack?
Technically, you could get him for prowling, though, or trespassing on your lawn.
Yeah, probably could. So it's pretty tough being a romantic these days because you will get arrested. We've talked a lot about the greatest TV shows of all time, but what about the greatest TV episode of all time? We asked the question on the KBJ Show Facebook page, and it was really kind of interesting to me because when I looked at the answers that we had there, and then I looked at the Ranker website, which is really cool because they have people on there ranking things, and you can upvote, downvote things, and so it's people kind of giving their own thoughts on it. When you look at the Ranker list of the greatest TV episodes ever, you see a lot of dramas on there. And in fact, at number one, they've got one and two. They have Breaking Bad episodes that are the top for Ranker. And then you see Game of Thrones has number three and number four on there. And then Breaking Bad's got another one that is in there and another Game of Thrones. So out of the top 10, there's three Breaking Bad, three Game of Thrones episodes, according to Ranker. And that's people that are just random wherever in the world going on there and saying what they think is the best. And there's a lot of dramas. In fact, there's only one that I would consider to be, well, maybe two, a comedy. You got an episode of The Office called Stress Relief.
It was seriously, they played after the Super Bowl, and it was such a great episode. I remember watching going, oh my gosh, this is so funny. And I was already a big fan.
And what a good time to do it,
and
too.
It was great. And they credit that with getting a lot more Office fans because of that.
Yeah, I could see that. Yeah, it's an employee starts a fire in the office to test everybody's fire safety skills.
That's probably my second or third favorite. The dinner party from The Office is my all-time favorite. I love that so much. I believe they won an Emmy for that as well.
Did they? Okay. The other, I guess, what you could consider a comedy at number nine for the Ranker list, they've got Jurassic Bark from Futurama, where Fry comes across the fossils of his dog at a museum and then acquires the remains to get him cloned so they can have a happy dog man duo once again. So that's the really only two comedies. So when you go to Ranker, people are looking at dramas. Now, when you look to the KBJ Show Facebook page, you are seeing a lot of comedies that are on here, or just, you know, kind of like mindless little sitcoms and things like that. I see on the list a lot of Seinfeld, a lot of Friends, some Curb Your Enthusiasm, The Office. That pretty much dominates the top comments that people said were their favorite episodes.
I have some of those on my list.
Yeah, so when you're talking about the best TV episodes of all time, our audience really likes the comedies. I know, Virginia, you like Seinfeld.
I do. My two favorite Seinfelds probably are Ass Man and Master of My Domain.
Okay. All right. Some of the ones that people were listing as their favorite. Kelly said The Marine Biologist.
That's a great one, too.
Man Hands is good.
Rachel said the Parking Garage episode. I'm not sure which one that is.
I have to go back to that one, but Marine Biologist is pretty damn amazing.
And Tina said the Puffy Shirt episode.
That's
Puffy Shirt is good.
That's Larry David's favorite Seinfeld episode.
Is it really? Yes. Okay.
Soup Nazi is good.
Uh-huh. I like the one where the horse ate the beefaroni and then had the farts.
Yes.
That was pretty good. I like the fart comedy.
I like the one when Jerry's dating the girl and she always wears the same outfit on every date. And
yeah,
but she has a bunch of different outfits. It's the same outfit.
It's the same one.
Yeah. Whoa. The beefaroni was rusty. Whoa, rusty.
Rusty. Yeah.
Whoa, rusty.
For Friends, the favorite episodes, and there were many that people listed. The one where Ross got high is Jamie's favorite. Renee said the pivot episode. Dava said the episode where Ross can't get the leather pants on. And Rita said the one with Ross's tan. So I didn't realize Ross was such a popular guy from Friends, but a lot of people's favorite episodes on the KBJ Show Facebook page put that. Now for The Office, people who loved Office episodes.
There's just so many.
Erica put Dinner Party.
That's mine.
Colleen said Pam and Jim's Wedding, where Kevin stuck his feet in the ice maker, said
it's
his
good.
Dogs were barking.
It's good.
The Christmas Gift Exchange is Debbie's favorite episode, is hers. And then there were some other ones. Curb Your Enthusiasm got a couple as well.
The best curve, in my opinion, is when he's friends with the Crazy Ice Killer. It's a rapper.
Crazy Ice Killer?
Yeah, it's really, really good.
Lisa said hers was where Larry David did the obituary for the aunt and replaced the A with the C.
Beloved aunt, and they made a typo, and it's beloved. No A there. They put a different letter.
It replaced the A, yes. Yeah. Instead of ant.
It's a really good episode.
We'll love it.
That's a pretty good concept. Katie said her favorite Curb Your Enthusiasm episode was the Chef Tourette's.
Yeah, I mean, it's an amazing episode. It's one of my favorite. It's a season finale.
Okay.
It's really good.
Yeah. So those are some of the ones. Some of the other just random episodes. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air got a couple nods for the best TV episode of all time. Carrie said the Carlton striptease dance was her favorite TV episode of all time. And Safina said the episode with Father.
Oh, that's the heavy
yeah,
one.
Yeah, that's the one where Will Smith, you know.
They would throw the heavy episode. You wouldn't see it coming, and then boom, heavy, Fresh Prince. Those are always my favorite kind of sitcoms because they go just full on the seriousness and the overacting, and I love it.
Yeah. Jamie said her favorite TV episode of all time is the Saved by the Bell where Jesse gets addicted to speed for a minute, starts freaking out while singing I'm So Excited.
You could argue it's one of the best moments / terrible moments. I mean, it's so cheesy. It's everything I love.
Everything
over
you love.
Over the top acting. She gets addicted to
speed.
It's not speed. It's those the
caffeine pills.
It's low budget drugs.
Girl. That can't even give you a good buzz.
I don't know if you guys have ever seen the full episode, but it's really...
I've only seen the scene.
Oh, it's great.
It's good.
In fact, I'm going to watch it today.
Okay, one of the best TV episodes of all time.
Because you just can't get enough KVJ. The KVJ Replay on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike. However, you are seeing some slowdowns in the area of the West Palm Service Plaza on both sides of the Turnpike. Give yourself some extra time through that area. And in Broward County on 95 northbound, you are under speed between Copens Road and Hillsborough Boulevard. Also moving slowly on the southbound side between Copens Road and Sunrise Boulevard. Give yourself some extra time there this morning. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
I know how frustrating it can be to try to lose weight, and you're not able to do it. And it gets harder every year that ticks on by. It could be the things that are in your food that are keeping you from losing weight, because it was kind of crazy. Even people who had the same calories and ate basically the same kind of foods and exercised the same amount, from 40 years ago, you have 10% larger body mass than they did. What's the difference? Well, it's all those things, and your hormones are all jacked up. So when you go to Wellington Anti-Aging for hormone replacement therapy, you can get them more in balance. And I noticed when I started my hormone replacement therapy, it sped up my metabolism. I had more energy. I was a better version of myself. Plus, they have those kind of medications that can get the weight off your body. Look, we're fighting against what we're eating, and this is the way to make that battle fair. Just go online today for your free consultation at WellingtonAntiAging.com. That's WellingtonAntiAging.com.
Nothing adds crunch to a salad quite like a fresh bell pepper. If the bell peppers you're buying don't sound like this, then they're not fresh from Florida. Florida bell peppers are grown right here in the Sunshine State by our hardworking local farmers. That means they're fresher, crisper, and have a way better... Bell peppers are in season now. So look for the Fresh from Florida logo or ask for it by name where you shop. Fresh from Florida, there's sunshine in every...
Strax Aesthetics unlocks the secret to great cosmetic surgery. Have surgery now and pay later. Breast augmentations and tummy tucks less than $150 per month for qualified patients. Extreme weight loss with a gastric sleeve procedure. The Strax Med Spa offers Botox for $9.99 per unit and unbeatable prices on Juvederm. Guaranteed to beat any comparable quote. Schedule a free face-to-face consultation with your actual board-certified surgeon. Saturday appointments available too. Visit StraxPlastics.com or call 954-749-3040 for more info.
If you're tired of your glasses and contact lenses, let me tell you about a LASIK procedure at Panu Laser and why you should do it. One, you're going to get rid of the aggravation you have with your glasses and contact lenses, going to the beach, the pool. It's going to be a lot easier also to the gym. Not to mention, it is really of a sound financial decision.
because you pay this one price for your LASIK procedure. I did mine 10 years ago, and I've already had it pay for itself five times over and what I would have spent in lenses and frames and solutions. It saved me money, and it's easier to deal with. I went to Panu Laser because of the expertise of Dr. Mutiella. He's performed over 100,000 LASIK procedures using only brand new state-of-the-art lasers. And there's even a payment plan that he offers, too, with zero down and zero interest, so you don't need any money for a full 12 months. While you book your consultation, drop my name, Kevin from the KBJ Show, and get an additional $500 off. Just go to PanuLaser.com. That's P-A-N-N-U Laser.com.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton, and at birchlane.com.
My day just flows better when I make my first stop McDonald's. I can choose two of my faves and save big when I bundle a savory sausage McMuffin or flaky sausage biscuit with crispy hash browns for breakfast for $2.89. Or I can make Mickey D's my last stop. Lunch, dinner, a late night snack, perhaps. When I bundle a hot and spicy McChicken or juicy McDouble with delicious small fries for only $3.89. Now my day is made the tastiest way when I bundle and save at McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid when product served.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like how refreshingly cold it is, but the rest of your body, oh yes, it's gonna relish every moment of it, because there are drinks. Then there are drinks from McDonald's.
Try any size frozen drink, like a frozen Fanta Blue Raspberry or a tasty frozen Coke for $1.49. At participating McDonald's, Coca-Cola and Fanta are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
For more than 20 years now, Dr. Rosenthal has been giving beautiful faces to Palm Beach County. This is what he does. Dr. Rosenthal is an expert when it comes to plastic surgery of the face. Anything that you need, from those beautiful lifts, that in-office facelift, to a full facelift, to rhinoplasty, to eyelid lifts, neck lifts, like all the facial things, Dr. Rosenthal is an expert at. He did my daughter's rhinoplasty, and she barely even had a bruise. I could not believe it. He did my girlfriend's beautiful lift, and I got to be in office with that and watch that. Wow, was that the coolest thing? Rosenthal-MD.com. 20 years of expertise, 20 years of experience, and elevated care. You're going to love the way they treat you, but most of all, you're going to love your results. Rosenthal-MD.com. That's Rosenthal-MD.com.
Ew, gotta get rid of this old Backstreet Boys t-shirt.
Tell me why.
Because it stinks, boys.
Tell me why.
I've washed it so many times, but the odor won't come out.
Tell me why.
No, you tell me why I can't get rid of this odor.
Have you tried Downy Rinse and Refresh? It doesn't just cover up odors, it helps remove them.
Wow, it worked, guys.
Yeah.
Downy Rinse and Refresh removes more odor in one wash than the leading value detergent in three washes. Find it wherever you buy laundry products.
Get ready for an out-of-this-world space adventure inspired by NASA missions with space explorers, The Infinite, at the Kravis Center, June 4th through September 2nd. Embark on the International Space Station and join the crew of astronauts for a spacewalk that'll leave you changed forever. Don't miss the chance to discover this unique immersive experience. The Infinite, June 4th through September 2nd at the Kravis Center.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach. Portions of the following program have been pre-recorded.
Kellogg's is trying to get your kids healthier by not junking them all up completely with their sugary cereals. In fact, they recommend that you need to take part healthy cereal and part trashy cereal and mix them together to improve the health of your kids.
So stupid. Just eat a healthy cereal. This is dumb, dog. Their theory is, I don't like it.
Yeah, I guess they still want to sell their sugary cereals. This is how they do it. Trying to be responsible so that your kids aren't just eating pure sugary cereals. So they say take, for instance, like Frosted Mini Wheats and put it with Special K.
It seems as if this is a ploy to get Kellogg's, just people talking about them, just or whatever's going on.
Well, they can sell double cereal now.
Yeah, it's a stunt.
Virginia. Oh, no, Mom. Oh, to be a good mom, you need two boxes of cereal, one sugary and one healthy.
We see you, Kellogg's. Yeah.
And cereal has gone up a lot.
It really has. There's a cereal price problem here in America.
Yeah, like with everything, huh?
No one's talking about the cereal issues.
Yeah, you're right. They're worried about other things with inflation. What the heck, man? So if you had to mix and do a mashup of cereals, what is the best combinations you could do?
Great topic, Kevin.
Okay.
Okay.
And glad you like it.
I tried to edit it down. I gave you five examples.
Oh, okay, good.
I had to stop.
Had a lot more.
Yeah, and there really is rhyme or reason for all this. And I swear to you, I've tried all of these. I've done the work on this.
Oh, I know you have.
Captain Crunch, the Crunch Berries mixed with Fruity Pebbles. Yeah, your mouth is going to be a little sore, but oh, the taste, okay. Baby. The
it's
taste.
Worth the pain.
It is worth. Just power through it.
Yeah.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch and Frosted Flakes, but go a little bit heavier on the Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, so maybe two parts to one?
Yeah, two parts to one, exactly. Two parts CTC to one part Frosted Flakes.
Okay,
yeah,
I got you. It's just adding a little extra.
Number three on my list, Cookie Crisp. I love Cookie Crisp.
Okay,
I'm sure you did Fat Kevin as well. With the Craves chocolate cereal, you got chocolate on chocolate right there.
Oh.
So you're going to have a great after milk issue, which really isn't an issue.
Okay.
It's a great delight.
What is this Crave you speak of?
It's when you bite into it, it's got chocolate in the middle of it. It's one of the higher sugary cereals out there. It looks like
Where have I been? I don't think I've ever heard of Crave.
This cereal was not around when you got out of the cereal game.
Yeah.
It's been around for a while, but
Crave, is it K or they spell it crazy or is it K-R-A-V-E?
Let me just double check on that. I want to make sure I get you the right literature.
Okay. You ever heard of this, Virginia?
Crave? I think I have, but it's newer.
It's newer, but newer as in not... Not
I mean, already,
new.
I'm learning so much.
Yeah, and the reason why I did go with Crave there, and it does work, because it is chocolate on chocolate. And it gives you kind of a twofer, great cereal taste, then great
after. I see what you're doing there.
Okay.
I can respect that.
Apple Jacks and Fruit Loops together.
Yeah, okay.
It does, and again, it gives you a different kind of after milk, but it's fruitier, a little healthier fruit.
Just what they're talking about with Kellogg's.
The most controversial one, the Reese's Puffs, you know that cereal, Virginia?
Yes.
Along with Lucky Charms, and let me tell you why.
Okay.
Because Lucky Charms has got the marshmallow, and the marshmallow with the Reese's Puffs is going to marry nicely. On top of that, the grain part of the Lucky Charms is almost kind of benign. It's not going to get in the way of your chocolatey peanut butter flavor.
Mm-hmm.
It's more, again, you want to go 2-1 on that ratio.
Okay.
And more with the marshmallows than the actual grain pieces. And that's all I got.
Some people have thrown in a few suggestions here. Oreo O's and Reese's Puffs.
I love it. They have the gift.
Okay. What about Frosted Flakes and Corn Flakes?
No, because basically a Corn Flake is just an untalented Frosted Flake.
Yeah, you're just kind of taking away a little bit of the awesome. You're not adding to
it. Well, a cornflake is a Frosted Flake without any of the superpowers. What are we doing?
Yeah, okay, so that ain't going
to
fly.
Well, cornflakes, everybody knows, the only way to make them good is to add a ton of sugar.
Yeah, duh. I mean, come on.
And this is, you're asking what's the best combination, not what the best health combination is.
Sure, okay, yeah. This is just different little things. Cap'n Crunch and Fruity Pebbles.
I don't hate it, and I see you.
Okay.
I do. I love it.
Okay. Cocoa Pebbles and Reese's Puffs.
I mean, it's right in the pocket.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is working for you.
I haven't heard a bad suggestion yet.
Okay, so far it's really good. Honey Nut Cheerios and Honey Bunches of Oats.
Honey Nut Cheerios. That's going to work. It's going to work because you're not bringing in that weak-ass regular Cheerio to bland it out. You've got both of your Cheerios that are respectively on their own sugary steroids, if you know what I mean.
Okay. Frosted Mini Wheats and Honey Bunches of Oats with Almonds.
You lost me at Mini Wheats. Gosh.
Okay, just two.
They're sugary Brillo pads.
Yeah.
I do not like them.
Honey Nut Cheerios and Frosted Flakes. What do you think about that cereal combination?
I don't hate it. It's not the best one, but I don't hate it. It's good. I feel like I'm hogging the conversation, Virginia. You got no.
You're the expert.
I don't eat any of these. I really don't. My kids eat it, but that I just don't eat cereal. Like,
this is all you.
Please give me your feedback.
This is all you.
Did you do the Reese's Puffs and Cap'n Crunch? Did we do that one yet?
I did not do it personally, but I don't hate that.
Okay, you think that could work?
The only one that didn't sound good was the Frosted Flakes and the Corn Flakes. That's the only suggestion I think is not very good.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch and Golden Grahams.
Hell yeah. Golden Grahams is underrated, and I like when it gets soggy.
Okay. Lucky Charms plus Cinnamon Toast Crunch plus Cheerios.
See, I don't think you need the Cheerios, and I'll tell you why. You got Lucky Charms in there already acting as your Cheerio.
Yeah, you already got your oat-based cereal right there.
If you came in here with a Honey Nut Cheerio, we could have a serious conversation. But now, it's hard for me to take it seriously.
Okay. All right. I think we've covered these. Cocoa Pebbles and Lucky Charms, did we do that one? Cocoa Pebbles, Lucky Charms.
I would go 2-1. Two to the Cocoa Pebble or Cocoa Pebbles.
So the mixture is very key here.
Yeah, it is. And especially when you're dealing with the Lucky Charms, you even want to do a combination within the Lucky Charms, meaning you want more marshmallows to oat.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So we got some good combinations there. So you can argue which is the best of all time.
I could have done that segment for another 20 minutes.
Okay. We probably left a lot there. Somebody said, by the way, this segment brought to you by the American National Diabetes Association.
Don't come to me for health.
Yeah.
Physical or mental.
You're right. We're not going for the healthy route here today, folks.
Let me tell you. Girl, you my little boo thing. So I'll give a hoot what you do, say, girl, I know you a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Put a little gold in the teeth and it fit good, so I took the doors out the deep, okay. I see a brother holding your seat, no beef, but I'm trying to get the noise you release. Don't take my talking to your own. I can keep it chill like the Soviet young blunt. I'ma keep it real when your man long gone. If you're looking for a friend and you got the wrong song, baby girl, what's good? What's with ya? If you book tonight, that's fiction. I'm outside, no pictures. You want me, go figure. To the back, to the front. You a 10, baby girl, but I'm the one. Hey, to the back. To the front, you a 10, baby girl, but I'm the one. You my little boo thing, so I'll give a hoot what you do, say, girl, I know. You a little too tame, I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next, tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next, tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. So I'll give a hoot what you do, say, girl, I know. You a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know.
Think fast, think fast. If you don't come in first, you might as well be last. Think fast.
Okay. Trying to wake it up here for a Monday morning. Shake off all the cobwebs from the weekend. So there's a lot going on.
So many cobs.
So many whims.
Yeah. All right, it's a round of Think Fast. We got Virginia, Jay Bird, and Denny's. I've got a topic for you. Whoever can come up with the most sensible answer, the fastest, is going to get a point here. First up, name something on an animal that starts with the letter M.
Moo mouth.
Okay, we could go with Moo Mouth. That works.
I almost said moose. I don't know what that means.
I said Mark.
Okay. A moose named Mark.
Oh, man. Hey, Virginia, hey. Again.
She's good.
She is. She really is.
Yep. Okay, next up, how about this? A food starting with the letter T.
Taco.
Oh, damn it, bro. Do you want this?
pep talk? Is that what we're doing over
there? I'm doing pep talk.
He's doing a pep taco.
That's good. Pep taco.
That's very good.
Okay, how about this? It is a Post Malone song starting with the letter C.
Charles!
Got it, sir. You had it loaded.
I
had better now loaded.
I circles loaded.
Damn.
Okay. All right, Bird.
I guessed right, Danny.
Gets yes. on the board.
Never happened.
Okay, how about a Taylor Swift song starting with the letter L?
Love Story.
Oh!
I had to go to an old one. Jeez.
Denny's gets on the board.
He's a Swifty, dog.
Get it.
You know it.
He is an old Swifty, around. Isn't he?
Sold out shows.
Okay, a Lady Gaga song starting with the letter S.
Shallow.
Oh!
Shallow, right? That counts.
My brain hurts.
Good, Denny's. I can tell Bradley Cooper.
Yeah, I can tell.
Could you tell?
Okay, Virginia and Denny's are now tied at two apiece. Bird's got one.
Oh.
How about this? A Michael Jackson song that starts with the letter R. What you got?
Not up on my Michael Jackson.
Do you?
Do what? You remember?
Okay.
Oh my gosh. I don't know if I know time. Enough.
Oh.
Remember the time.
Oh.
It starts with the R. Oh. It's remember the time.
This is fun. I like this. This could be a little game here.
A little twist.
Yeah.
Yeah, got a little twist.
Yeah. What do you guys think? That could be its own game.
Oh, they could.
Just artist. I'm having fun.
Okay. Well, that's what it's all about, right? Okay, Virginia with two, still Denny's with two. G-Bird has got one. Okay, next up, it is a country in South America starting with the letter C.
Colombia!
I will go with that. Bird has tied it all up.
Oh,
the
two,
next
two.
One wins.
Dang.
Next point wins. Okay.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, yeah. Here
all
we
right,
go.
How do you feel the tension? I'm standing for this one.
Okay. Here we go. It's a country in Europe that starts with the letter B.
Belgium.
Oh, oh
Virginia knocks it out of the park.
She's a worldly woman.
Yeah, she
she's globetrotting.
Never been.
And it is.
Yeah, you've been to the Bahamas.
You love their chocolate.
You've been around.
Would you have accepted Bahamas?
Yeah, no, it's not your thing.
But your world.
Yeah.
Yeah. saying no, no. If you wanna be with me, baby, there's a price to pay. I'm not cheating, I'm not cheating, I'm not on me. If you wanna be with me, I can make you wish come true. You gotta make a big impression, gotta like what you do. If you wanna be with me, baby, there's a price to pay. I'm not cheating, I'm not on me. You gotta love me, you gotta pay. If you wanna be with me, I can make you wish come true. Just come and set me free, baby, and I'll be with you. I'm a genie in a bottle, baby. Come on and let me out.
KVJ Replay on 97.9 WRMF.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike. However, you are seeing some slowdowns in the area of the West Palm Service Plaza on both sides of the Turnpike. Give yourself some extra time through that area. And in Broward County on 95 northbound, you are under speed between Copens Road and Hillsborough Boulevard. Also moving slowly on the southbound side between Copens Road and Sunrise Boulevard. Give yourself some extra time there this morning. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
At Begin Anew, there is a team of anti-aging experts that want to help you with any kind of angle. Maybe you're looking to lose weight. At Begin Anew, they've got the semaglutide. They've got the peptides. They've got the triziptide, or however you say it. They've got all the tides to help you lose the weight. And when you drop my name, get $75 off the cost of your treatment at Begin Anew. Also at Begin Anew, they can show you how they can do that total optimal wellness check, where they check out everything, including your hormones, nutrients, deficiencies, food sensitivities. They check out everything, and that's just $149 with your qualifying insurance. You're also going to love their skin treatments. I love their hydrofacials combined with the dermaplaning. Oh, my skin feels so amazing after that. But they've also got the Morpheus 8, peels, photofacials, laser hair removal right there on Indian Town Road in Jupiter. BeginAnewMed.com.
Hi, it's Randy, and my Easter tradition is with the Honey Baked Ham Company.
Because there's nothing like it. And look, you got to shop early and avoid the rush. Honey Baked's complete Easter meals are impressive, delicious, but they're convenient. That's my favorite part. Spend less time in the kitchen, more time with family. Complete meals, bone-in, boneless ham, smoked and roasted turkey breasts, the side dishes are available for any size gathering. And those heat and serve sides are just super convenient. You put them in the microwave or the oven. They're ready in as little as 15 minutes. If you're hosting brunch, not dinner this year, did you know that Honey Baked's take and bake sliders and biscuits are amazing? Check this out. Ham and Swiss sliders, garlic herb turkey and cheddar sliders, and the ham and cheddar biscuits. I'm so hungry just thinking about it. And don't forget about dessert. Honey Baked has those decadent cakes and pies as well. And you got to get it at Honey Baked Ham. They got you covered for Easter brunch and dinner or any of your spring gatherings. The meals are delicious, easy to serve, and convenient. HoneyBaked.com. Place an order for pickup. Find a store near you and see the extended store hours. Walk-in customers are always welcome too. And Happy Easter from Honey Baked Ham.
You call that a precision stop?
When a rookie stunt driver,
just give me a shot,
meets the trainer who thought he'd seen it all.
Come on, focus.
They'll soon find out that behind the wheel of the Nissan Rogue, with the power of VC Turbo and the most fuel-efficient gas-powered engine in its class,
watch this,
the protege can become a master. But this is no ordinary blockbuster. It's a Nissan sales event ad.
Level up your drive with 1.9% APR financing for 60 months on the 2023 Nissan Rogue. Shop the Nissan sales event. Visit your local Nissan store and NissanUSA.com today. Auto Pacific segmentation excluding hybrids and electric vehicles. 2024 APR fuel economy estimates from 28 City 34 Highway to 30 City 37 Highway for 2024 Nissan Rogue. Actual mileage may vary. For well qualified buyers, 1.9% APR financing for 60 months on new 2023 Rogue and dealer stock. Example, 60 months financing at $1,748 per month per thousand financed. Actual down payment may vary. Subject to residency restrictions and NMAC credit approval. Not all buyers qualify. Dealer contribution may affect actual price set by dealer. Contact dealer for details. Ends 4-124.
Rapids Water Park. Mega thrills. Mega fun.
And coming later this spring, new Mega Mayhem, the first dueling water coaster in Florida. Visit now for spring break and come back for Mega Mayhem with a season pass. Save 45% and get a free souvenir cup now through April 3rd. Only at South Florida's Mega Thrill Capital, Rapids Water Park. It's Mega 2024.
Hey, West Palm Beach. Looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on unlimited welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
Looking to make a change and start your weight loss journey? Hey, it's Suits from the KVJ Show, and I got to tell you, I am loving the way I look right now because I dropped 30 pounds, and I was able to do it in just 2 months with the help of Coastal Weight Loss Secret. Dr. Adam Zuckerman and his team over at Coastal Weight Loss Secret have a unique weight loss program that made it easy for me to lose that weight, get healthy, and get my energy back naturally, safely, and effectively. If you've tried weight loss programs in the past and have been unsuccessful, maybe you couldn't lose the weight, or once you did lose the weight, you put it right back on as soon as the program ended, you've got to give them a call. With Coastal Weight Loss Secrets, you can lose that unhealthy fat without counting points or calories. There's no exercising required, no surgeries, and none of those expensive prepackaged meals. They can help you find out the secret to losing up to a pound of fat every day, and then once you lose that weight, they'll help you keep the weight off. Schedule a free consultation today with the team at Coastal Weight Loss Secrets. You can reach them at 561-680-3090. That's 561-680-3090, or visit them online at Coastal WeightLossSecret.com.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
It's mainly clear skies this morning, some patchy fog. Inland temperatures are mild in the low to mid-70s to kick off our Monday, then heating up to high of 90 this afternoon before a few thunderstorms arrive late in the afternoon and evening. A few of those storms could be strong. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Snyder, serving Florida families for over 50 years. Warm weather is almost here. When you're fighting the South Florida heat, you can rely on Snyder's HVAC expertise to take care of your home and keep you comfortable today, tomorrow, and 10 years from now. Snyder is here and ready to serve you. Schedule today, SnyderAC.com.
The KVJ replay continues right now, only on 97.9 WRMF.
All right, little kid or drunk adult, we all do dumb things. Sometimes we're little kids, other times we are drunk adults. Can you tell the difference? You can play along, too, and get your submissions in on the WRMF app. There's something called the mic drop feature. It's a little microphone that is right there in the bottom corner of the app. When you open it up, you can leave us some audio. Just tell us the dumb thing you did. Leave a little bit of space in the audio, and then tell us whether you're a little kid or drunk adult and a little bit more to the story. Here is Jimmy's submission on the dumb thing he did. What did you do, Jimmy?
I threw up on the ET ride at Universal Studios.
Okay, threw up on the ET ride at Universal Studios.
It's not a fast-moving ride.
Yeah.
But they do serve alcohol at Universal.
I can't believe that thing's still out. They still have the ET ride.
Do they?
Do they?
Not sure.
I don't know.
I think they do.
Do they?
I don't know. I thought they went
to Islands of Adventure recently, and I haven't been to Universal in a minute.
Okay. Well, what do you think? Does this sound like a little kid or a drunk adult here?
Little kid.
I'm pulling for drunk adult.
Drunk adult, okay. All right. Yeah, I kind of think maybe it would be a drunk adult, like you said. It just doesn't seem fast enough to make somebody barf. And I was a little kid that barfed on everything. I don't think I would barf on that one. So, Jimmy, were you a little kid or a drunk adult?
I was a drunk adult. I smuggled vodka into a trip with my brother's family, and nobody knew I was hammered until I came back around to the beginning of the ride with barf all over my shirt. My little nephew was traumatized, and that was back in the late 90s, and I haven't vacationed with him since.
One and done, huh? Okay. He's out.
Yeah, people are saying it's still there.
Nice.
Okay, so if you want to get drunk and barf on it, it's still there for you.
Is the barf still there or just the ride?
I can't believe they still have that ride.
I hope they cleaned up the barf.
That is amazing. Okay, we got Megan here. Megan, what is the dumb thing you did?
I sneezed in a boy's face right before our first kiss.
Sneezed in a boy's face right before our first kiss.
I mean, I guess that's better than farting, right?
I don't know.
If he's down there, you're kissing the wrong place.
Well, yeah. That's not what I mean.
I don't think you
for
know how
first
to go.
Kiss, that's that aggressive.
That's not where I make my first kiss.
No.
That's the wrong set.
At least for the second date.
I think this is a drunk adult.
Drunk adult. Okay, what do you think, Virginia?
I think it's a little kid.
I think it's a little kid? Okay, I'm going to go with drunk adult. For some reason, when I'm drinking, I sneeze a little bit more, and maybe you just like, it catches up with you. So I'll go with Bert on this. What were you here, Megan?
I was a little kid. I was like in sixth grade, and I was at the mall with a boy, and my parents were waiting outside to pick me up, and my boyfriend tried to give me a kiss, but he didn't realize that when I get nervous, I sneeze a lot, and I just sprayed right in his face. And I was so mortified. I just like, gotta go, bye. And I ran out, and he never got the first kiss, needless to say.
Amazing. So the first kiss never happened after you sneezed in his face. That's tough. Okay, what about Nick? What was the dumb thing that happened with you?
Hey, KVJ. So here's my story. I was kicked by a pony.
Kicked?
I know that move.
By a pony. Bird was kicked by a pony, too.
On my birthday, in front of my crush.
Okay.
It was very traumatizing.
Hashtag team pony.
Oh, I wish I had that on tape. Oh, my God. Oh, it was instant tears. It was awful. Right in front of my crush, who's 3 years older. It was drunk adult, Kevin.
Drunk adult, Bird's going with. What do you think, Virginia?
I'm going little kid.
I'm
going
to go with little kid, too, just kind of like what Jay Bird was. What were you here, Nick?
I was a little kid. I was at a birthday party, and some other kid tried to feed the pony, didn't ride, saw the kids some ice cream. And I just happened to be standing behind it at the time. And apparently the pony loved the cookies and cream so much that it just pulled off and kicked me right in the chest.
Wow.
And I was, just crying, and all the other kids were laughing at me. So that's my story. Little kid.
Damn.
I think people, those ponies all, maybe it was a Lake Park thing. I was always at some kind of a party with either a pony, a horse, or some type of animal. It was big.
It's a big thing. Pony parties are big. They do it in my neighborhood, too. And then the old lady across the street called the HOA and said, "There's wild animals. I'm in fear."
Well, you should fear the pony if you try to get up from the butt area. I think that's what happened. I tried to get from behind her. All right, shut up.
What are you trying to do to the pony's butt?
Stop talking, Bert.
What a weirdo. I agree with the pony. Kick him.
You're right. Maybe I was
I'm trying to Me Too the pony. Yeah.
Pony's
on
had
his
that
butt.
Before. It's like, oh, not again.
Not again.
Not again. Uh-uh. One time. That's it.
I smell a perv sneaking up behind me.
That's not what I meant. I misspoke again.
I don't trust this little squirrely kid. All right, Virginia got a perfect score right now.
Ooh.
3 for 3. Can she make it 4 for 4 with Lisa? What is the dumb thing you did, Lisa?
So I set a cage full of hamsters free in a pet store.
Does that sound like something a little kid would do or a drunk adult?
Both.
What ain't Virginia?
It does sound like both.
It sounds like both.
Uh-huh.
I'm going drunk adult.
So you're
going
to go drunk adult. That is her guess. Bird, what do you think?
I'm going drunk adult.
Going to go drunk adult as well. Okay. And I will go little kid just to be different. What were you, Lisa?
I was a drunk adult. My brother came to pick me up from a bar after I got too hammered at a Saturday brunch. And on the way to his apartment, he needed a stop to get his dog at the groomer's before they closed. And it was in this, like, pet store. And he didn't want to leave me in the hot car. So he was like, just come in with me. Like, just let me get the dog, and that's it. So when he was getting the dog, I tried to kiss a hamster after opening its cage. And it didn't like that. So it bit my lip. And I knocked the cage over, letting three more hamsters escape. Oh. And couldn't get them back in the cage and left immediately.
Wow. Okay. Good heavens. That's pretty involved there. Virginia, you got yourself a perfect score here.
Well, I mean, drunk adult. I do specialize in drunk adult.
Okay.
Great job.
Yeah, I know. Congrats.
I've been doing the work.
Yeah, put in the time. Very nice. I only talk to God when I need a favor. And I only pray when I ain't got a prayer. So who the hell am I? Who the hell am I to expect a savior? Oh, if I only talk to God when I need a favor. God, I need a favor. I know amazing grace, but I ain't been living them words. Swear I spend more Sundays drunk off my ass than I have in church. Hardcover King James, only been saving dust on the nightstand. And I don't know what to say.
Like Hail Marys, if you're still there, Lord, spare me. Oh my God, Hail Mary. Hanging in there, just barely throwing up prayers. Like Hail Marys, if you're still there, Lord, spare me.
I got some weird stuff on eBay, and Jaybird sent me a very interesting list here of odd items and how much the going rate is for them right now on eBay. So I'll see if I can get Denny's in here to play along with Virginia to see if they can figure out exactly what the actual retail price is.
I was doing a deep dive with some of these items, and I might have to get some of them.
You are the kind of guy that would buy arm bones.
Mm. I really am. I would buy arm bones. No. You're right.
Are these real arm bones? Because people were saying that they didn't think you could traffic any kind of human items on social media.
So you're like a weirder version of Nicolas Cage without the money or fame.
So I read up on the... why do you got to be so mean? She's so evil for some reason. I don't know. The I read the description and they said it came from a science, one of those science rooms where it was a real skeleton.
Oh, really?
That's what they had said. Now, look, y'all take it up with eBay if you think they're lying. They could be, but they said they were real.
Okay. All right. So that is the first item that we have up for bids here, two human forearm bones. Virginia, how much do you think that's going for right now on eBay? What are they asking for?
I definitely think there's a weirdo out there that would pay $60.
$60?
It would have to be more than that, right?
You could tell somebody does not look for bones on eBay.
Right.
Especially if they're human
bones. I get my
bones
at home.
I imagine they have to be $200.
You're going with $200.
$100 a bone.
Okay, for
$100 a bone. That's good.
He put some thought into it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Denny's is $75 off, and Virginia is $65 off. She's going to get the point.
Whoa!
It's going for
$125. Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Do I actually get the bones? Because I got it right.
No.
Those are them BOGO bones.
Yeah.
Which it is. Is yeah. Like that.
Discount.
It is.
Price of a femur.
Okay, what do you think about this? eBay Price is Right. A t-shirt that has three possums singing to the moon.
This thing is nothing short of awesome. It is amazing looking.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I mean, they know their market. They are appealing to the right guy.
Denny's, you would love this shirt.
eBay's like, we suggest this item for you.
Yeah.
Denny's, how much do you think this is going for right now on eBay? What would you have to pay to get this lovely piece of clothing?
I'm going to start it off. I think it's $30.
Going to go with $30. Okay.
T-shirt.
What do you think, Virginia?
Is it new or used?
It's new.
Oh, good question.
Okay,
it's new. Very good question.
A lot of stuff on eBay is used, including bed sheets, which I'm just going to say right now.
Oh, my God.
That's
Why?
Gross.
That is gross.
I was on eBay looking for bed sheets, and I didn't realize you had to distinguish that you wanted new.
So I'm showing the shirt right now, Kevin, on KVJ
TV.
Wow. And was I lying?
That is pretty.
That thing is just too sweet.
Oh, wow. Man.
They make the possums look kind of terrifying. And I was trying to figure that out because I was having a little bit of a debate with somebody's texting in the other day about what is more terrifying, a coon or a possum.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought it was a raccoon because we even had that video of the raccoon chasing that lady and her dog into her house this week. And they were saying, no, possums can get squirrely too. I never heard that. I know they got crazy looking teeth, but they're kind of ugly. Yeah.
That tail too, that slithery tail.
They have a rat tail.
I thought they're all pretty peaceful though. I never heard a possum cornering somebody.
That's the difference. I think they're pretty peaceful. They just look horrible.
But out of 200 possums, you mean to tell me there's not one murderous possum out of 200? Just numbers say.
There's always one.
There's always one.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. All right. What are you going to pay for this, Virginia?
What did he say? 30?
He said $30, yes, for a t-shirt that has three possums singing to the moon on it.
I'm going to say 25.
Virginia is going to go with 25. The actual retail price is $16. Virginia's going to get the point again.
Oh, somebody knows they're weird.
I lowered my numbers here.
Yeah. Virginia's acing this quiz. All right,
Virginia
next up.
I would buy that for Jay Bird.
It's amazing.
He would be so happy.
Okay, eBay Price is Right. Third item up for bid is a vintage child's clown suit from the 1930s.
Oh, and it is horrifying. It is so creepy.
Wow.
Let me see if I can pull it up.
Oh, my gosh.
How much are you going to pay for a vintage child's clown suit from the 1930s on eBay, Virginia?
Wow, this thing has history.
Yeah.
It's
scary
antique.
Era for clowns.
Show me $55. Yes.
Okay. Denny's, what do you think the going price is right now?
From the 1930s?
1930s, yeah.
Kids clown suit.
Oh, my gosh. He just showed me the picture.
If you're watching KBJ TV, Jaber's got that up for you to see, to help you with your bid.
We could put Rocco in that.
This is available right now. I think it also comes with some kind of old-timey mannequin thingy.
Okay, I've been looking for a new way to mess with the golfers behind my house. If I put Rocco in that outfit with a goat head, people would run in fear.
Yeah, they've got the costume on some kind of a mannequin. I think the mannequin comes with it.
Oh, sweet.
What a bonus. Mm-hmm. That's the last thing you see before you die, right? I mean, it's old, it's vintage. I know regular costumes are expensive now, so I'm going to have to guess that it has to be $120.
$120 is what you're saying. You're both way off. Denny's, you're closer. It's going for 500 right now.
Whoa!
It's from, I mean, 1930s. Really old-timey. 1930s.
Mm-hmm.
The dirty 30s?
The dirty 30s.
All right, what about this item on eBay? An Elvis Presley pink Cadillac postage stamp beach towel from 1993. Oh. How much are you going to pay for this on eBay, Denny's?
I'm kicking it off. Oh, geez. 1993, vintage Elvis. I think it's got to go up in value. I'm going to say $200.
$200. Virginia, what's your guess on this? It is a pink Cadillac postage stamp beach towel from 1993.
I'm showing it off. It's beautiful.
I think, yeah, I remember that.
There's no way that thing is $200.
Okay.
90s.
I'm going 190.
You're going 190. Virginia's trying to box Denny's out here.
It's every round.
It's a dirty move.
It's a dirty move.
Dirty 30.
It's effective. It's only going for $25.
Okay. $25, that makes sense.
Yeah. And y'all, it looks used.
They made a lot of Elvis stuff.
Stuff on eBay, y'all. You got to do a stain check.
That one is not brand new.
I wouldn't buy a used towel.
No.
I wouldn't either.
Bed sheets and towels, no.
People's junk all over that thing?
Yeah.
I got one more here for you. eBay Price is Right. It's an unopened Mr. T air freshener from the 1980s.
Ooh.
Virginia, how much is that going for right now on eBay?
I would pity the fool that paid more than $28.
Okay, Denny's, what's your guess on that?
It's from the 80s. I'm going to have to say it's $68.
$68. Denny's is going high again. It's $9.96.
Oh,
Virginia gets
that is such worth it. I think this would be worth so much more.
We call that a bargain.
Yeah. Look at that.
Yeah.
And Virginia takes 4 out of 5.
Impressive.
Yeah.
What does the Mr. T air freshener smell like?
Well, especially now, if it's that old, does it even have scent?
Yeah, good question.
I wouldn't think that it would.
It's more of like a peacock piece.
Yeah. Oh,
it's not a about making your car smell
no,
good.
No. Yeah. You wouldn't take it out of the package if you bought it.
Oh,
yeah.
I would.
Mm-hmm. Hanging up.
I'm drowning in the
I'm right there at that age. Midlife crisis. It's kind of interesting the things that people will do as they get a little bit older, because you're kind of grappling with, you're not necessarily young, but you don't want to do all the old people things. So sometimes you can do things that look a little desperate and you say, wow, you would think maybe you would have aged out of that. The old staple is that, you know, for guys at least, they go get a sports car.
Right.
You know, because it keeps them hot and young and they want to. You know, it's just something to get to make them feel like, okay, I'm not completely losing it.
Sports car with a ponytail. I've seen that combo a lot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Maybe you have one, not the other. Who knows? Maybe you just go with the ponytail.
I mean, I have a ponytail, but I'm growing up because I know it looks bad.
Okay, all
right. I don't think it looks good.
Okay.
Or for comedy.
So what about a midlife crisis without the money? What is the cheapest midlife crisis you can have? And I started looking through some of these answers. I'm like, I have definitely gone through a few of these. I think I'm in a few right now.
But did you go through them because you were struggling with your age, or did you go through them because you just kind of liked what you were doing?
Well, I think what it is, because it is. I got to tell you, it's an interesting little rub that sometimes you've got to ask yourself, because, you know, you live your life how you have. And sometimes you forget that you're not 24 anymore and you're still kind of acting like you're 24. And then when people look at you, they're going, does he think he's 24? Because in my mind, sometimes I still think I'm 24. So some of the things that you can notice, and one that stood out to me of all the answers we had of the midlife crisis for people who can't afford a sports car: partying with your young adult children's friends. And that is definitely one I'm trying to be more aware of, because, yeah, I have gotten caught up in it. And
they're fun.
I remember my daughter's 21st birthday. We had the Pontiki, and I just went crazy and had a good time. And even just her last birthday that we had had. In March, I was out there, and, you know, the wife and I, we tried. My daughter, because she wants us to go. She's like, oh, come on the boat. And we're both like, we can't. Like,
we're just old.
It just doesn't look
it's
right.
It's a weird look.
You guys are out there doing shots and having a great time. And I did that a few years ago. And I looked at the photos. I'm like, oh, what are you doing?
If you could keep it together and not do the shots, I think it would work. But you're like me. If there's shots to be had, you want in.
Well, and then you don't want to be the wet blanket either.
Right.
Because everybody else is whooping it up. And then here you are standing over in the corner with your arms crossed, looking like you're not having a good time. So, yeah, the wife and I were just like, okay, we're trying to learn our lesson. I'm not over it, but that would be definitely one of my middle-aged faux pas. They start dressing like teenagers. Yes, that definitely can happen.
Totally. I've seen it.
Wait till you see what I wear tomorrow. You'd be like, oh, yeah, Kev's definitely going through it. I have got the same outfit that my 14-year-old son has that for some reason my wife and daughter thought I'd look great in. Trying to start a band. That's another thing. Guys sometimes wait till the middle age. A lot of kids will do that in high school. I know I started a band in high school, but nope. Some people are like, let's get a band going. Some guys will go out and buy an electric guitar and not know how to play, and then a couple weeks later after they give up, they just hang it on the wall in their man cave. Yeah, that's one of the signs, too.
The one, yeah, I'm going to play bass. They buy the bass book. They never do anything, and then they just hang it.
They just give up, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Bird, maybe this speaks to you. Another midlife crisis sign that's cheaper than buying a sports car: buying expensive vintage toys from your childhood.
Bring it on. I love it.
How much would you say have you spent just on toys displayed in your home? It's got to be.
I have no idea, honestly.
It's got to be in the tens of thousands.
I don't know. I bought a lot of stuff when it was cheap, and it's gone up in value, so it's really hard to say.
So it's an investment piece.
Well, you know, I don't want to brag, but the portfolio looks strong.
Another thing I see a lot, a midlife crisis when you can't afford a sports car: guys who love to smoke meat.
They get obsessed with it, and then they will talk smoked meat with you.
Oh, my gosh.
Even when they're not smoking meat. You could be away from a grill, they're talking about smoking meat with you.
I've found myself, as I've gotten a little bit older, the conversations are into grills and smoking meat. And I'm like, okay, if I want to hang in these conversations, I got to learn something about smoking meat, apparently.
You ever smoked meat?
No, I haven't, Virginia.
You're not a man yet.
I'm not a meat smoker.
There is, and I've noticed, too, a lot of times it's the person that loves to smoke the meat is a person who's not very happy in their marriage.
Oh.
And that smoked meat is all they have, and they've
really go all in on the smoked meat.
The meat replaces the love lost.
Wow.
The three different people I'm thinking that's into smoked meat. Horrible marriages for
children. She doesn't love me, but my smoked meat does.
I think I just, the passion's in the meat now.
Okay,
Not the bedroom.
Yeah. Another one is getting heavily into making sourdough bread.
Oh, my gosh. They ran out of yeast during the pandemic because so many people decided it was time to bake bread.
Yeah.
There was a yeast shortage.
They started becoming bread. Yeah, that was a big hobby for a lot of people.
Yeah.
Look, making your own bread, that does sound amazing because nothing is better than fresh out the oven bread. Mm. Oh.
But it got to a level of weirdness where people were really talking about the bread again, kind of like the smoked. It's basically smoked meat.
It is smoked meat. It's just a different thing. Yeah, one or the other. Also, another sign of the midlife crisis for people who can't afford a sports car. It's things they'll do to their body, like getting their first tattoo when they're like 45. Piercings that you would think would be reserved for somebody in their teens or early 20s, or dyeing your hair or facial hair an outrageous color.
The just for men look.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, I think it's even going like you're going to
get crazy
blue
color.
Hair.
Yeah.
Blue or pink.
Look how youthful I am.
Yes. Uh-huh. Some of the other things, too, have to do with relationships. Cheating on your significant other with somebody much younger. That was actually the top response we got on our Facebook page.
Damn.
People who start a hardcore drug habit, but just on the weekends.
50 gonna be the year of meth.
You know what? I just turned 50. Yeah, I'm gonna try some cocaine.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Yeah. All of a sudden, you're into clubbing on the weekends. That's an odd look.
Now, it is an odd look.
Is it odd if you go clubbing with other old people in an old person club? That's not odd. That's just depressing. But if you're the old person at the young person club, that's when it's creepy.
Yeah, if you're at Clematis Social and you're over 35, it's gone wrong.
Yeah. And I don't really know of many or any old person clubs.
Would that depress you?
Sailfish Marina. No, what is it? No, Waterway Cafe.
Do they dance, though?
Yes.
Do they really?
Oh, my gosh. I was in there, and I could not believe. There was old people in walkers on the dance floor.
No way.
I put a video up. I'm like, somebody come get your grandma, because they are here, and they are not going anywhere, and they are feisty.
Wow. So that's where the old people go to dance now.
Waterway Cafe.
Huh.
Would
that place has changed.
Would that be something you'd be into if the queen wanted to go to a dance club, but it was, you know, 50 and older? Is that depressing to you?
No, I wouldn't do it. She wouldn't do it. There's no way she'd do it either. But no, there's not a chance. Not a chance.
There's a place in Alton now where the older people like our age go. Yeah. And it's a restaurant at first, but then it turns kind of clubby. And it's not like
full. So Lenore's or another place?
It says restaurang. Instead of saying restaurant on the end, it says restaurang, which I don't understand that.
Okay.
But that place turns clubby after 10 p.m.
Okay. I'm good.
Imagine if you went out and you saw Kevin and the Queen doing serious dancing at a club. I was like, what's going on over here?
Oh, I'd be so happy.
I'd be happy, but I'd be like,
you'd be up there dancing with them.
But that's out of character for me. Of course I would be. If he and the queen were dancing together, but they were being serious and, you know, doing it like on a date, that wouldn't weird you out.
You should look at us odd, because you'd be like, there's something going on with
them.
Well,
that, they'd be drunk. They'd definitely
It'd still be
drunk.
Weird,
I'd be blackout.
It would still be weird to me.
I wouldn't even remember the conversation. I would have
blackout.
To be that drunk, yeah. I'd have to be blacked out drunk. Another thing, cheap midlife crisis, turning your garage into a video arcade. Okay. And caring way too much about your lawn. So there you go.
Yeah.
Just in case you missed it, the KVJ replay is on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike. However, you are seeing some slowdowns in the area of the West Palm Service Plaza on both sides of the Turnpike. Give yourself some extra time through that area. And in Broward County on 95 northbound, you are under speed between Copens Road and Hillsborough Boulevard. Also moving slowly on the southbound side between Copens Road and Sunrise Boulevard. Give yourself some extra time there this morning. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Hi, it's Randy for Sono Bello, and I find that spring can be a little challenging. You know, it's warmer weather, you're getting outside, you're moving around, you're feeling great because the weather's warmer, and then you go to the closet, and maybe the clothes that fit last year don't fit this year. Well, Sono Bello springs you into springtime shape in one visit. Microlaser fat removal is the difference maker that you've been searching for. Whether you have those, I give up frustrating areas, the tummy, the muffin top, the thighs, arms, wherever, Sono Bello doctors are the experts. One comfortable visit. The fat and inches are history, gone permanently. Invest in you now and have the best spring and summer ever. All it takes is one visit to Sono Bello. Schedule your free consultation. Learn how micro laser fat removal can change everything. You'll be shocked at how affordable this is. They offer low monthly payments, flexible financing that makes investing in yourself easy and affordable. Visit SonoBello.com/radio. That's SonoBello, B-E-L-L-O, .com/radio.
Want more speed? Then you're in luck, because Xfinity just increased their internet speeds, and they're faster than ever. Plus, with super fast internet and a reliable connection, you can do more of what you love whenever you want. More gaming, more downloading, more video chatting, and more cozy nights on the couch streaming your favorite movies and TV shows. If life with double the speed is sounding pretty awesome, that's because it is. It's time to get more out of your internet with faster speeds from Xfinity. Get 150 megabit Xfinity internet for only $20 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. That's double the speed for the same great price. Plus, for a limited time, learn how you can get a $100 prepaid card when you get more speed when you sign up online. Just go to Xfinity.com to switch today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Equipment taxes and other charges extra. After promo, regular rates apply. Actual speeds vary and not guaranteed.
Strax Aesthetics unlocks the secret to great cosmetic surgery. Have surgery now and pay later. Breast augmentations and tummy tucks, less than $150 per month for qualified patients. Extreme weight loss with a gastric sleeve procedure. The Strax Med Spa offers Botox for $9.99 per unit and unbeatable prices on Juvederm. Guaranteed to beat any comparable quote. Schedule a free face-to-face consultation with your actual board-certified surgeon. Saturday appointments available too. Visit StraxPlastics.com or call 954-749-3040 for more info.
Life Imaging FLA is doing something so cool. If you're like me and you're always wondering, oh man, what's going on the inside with my body, with my health, and you want to get clear answers, Life Imaging FLA will give you clear answers about your heart health with a free heart scan right now. All you need to do is bring a few minimum requirements, and Life Imaging FLA is going to give you this $699 value for free.
Yeah, 10 minutes, no dyes, no need to undress, and the cool thing, not only can you get the free heart scan, but you can also check out their cancer screening and their virtual colonography, so you don't ever have to mess with sedation.
More than 80% of the people are just like me and Kevin. They go to Life Imaging FLA, and the people tell them, you have zero blockages. That is good. That is peace of mind. But if you have a blockage, don't you want to know about it?
Life Imaging FLA is now offering this free heart scan with a few minimum requirements. All you have to do is from your cell call #250 and say the keyword free heart scan. That's #250, keyword free heart scan.
My day just flows better when I make my first stop McDonald's. I can choose two of my faves and save big when I bundle a savory sausage McMuffin or flaky sausage biscuit with crispy hash browns for breakfast for $2.89. Or I can make Mickey D's my last stop. Lunch, dinner, a late night snack, perhaps. When I bundle a hot and spicy McChicken or juicy McDouble with delicious small fries for only $3.89. Now my day is made the tastiest way when I bundle and save at McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid when product served.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like how refreshingly cold it is. But the rest of your body? Oh, yes. It's gonna relish every moment of it. Because there are drinks. Then there are drinks from McDonald's.
try any size frozen drink like a frozen Fanta Blue Raspberry or a tasty frozen Coke for $1.49. At participating McDonald's, Coca-Cola and Fanta are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Need a personal injury lawyer? Come rest and come rest. 844-411-1LAW. DemandDave.com.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medicine called Revelex. It is proven to work. Now, you probably heard about semaglutide. With all the celebrity buzz, it's an FDA-approved drug for weight loss, but nobody offers it like Red Mountain Weight Loss. Red Mountain Weight Loss includes full-strength semaglutide with their Revelex. But Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide medications. It comes in a full-strength daily tablet, so there's no needles, just results. Get with Revelex and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs all while eating a wide variety of foods like cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee, creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
A lot can happen between falling in love with a house online and owning it, between imagining living there and breathing in your new home for the first time. Having an advocate who can help you navigate the complex world of financing, inspections, negotiating, analyzing the market, and talking through any anxieties that may pop up, that can make all the difference. That's what the expertise of a Realtor can do for you. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors and bound by a code of ethics, because that's who we are.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Portions of the following program have been pre-recorded.
Well, Jaybird is a child of the 1980s. You just go into his house and you look around and it's pretty much 1984.
It's 80s and 90s, and I'm trying to morph into some 70s stuff, but man, 70s stuff is kind of expensive.
You could charge a ticket price at the door for people to walk through. It is a museum.
No, so much to do still. So much more to do. I got so many more ideas. It's... The ceiling hasn't even been utilized the way it needs to be.
You've lost your mind.
I, you know what? And it feels free. Yeah, I love it. I love it.
We got to turn this thing into a money-making venture. We're bleeding out, Jaybird. You spend so much.
Okay, well, let's see if Jaybird can get these 80s catchphrases right, meaning you have to name the show or the source of this catchphrase.
How many do you have?
How many do you want, Virginia? I could do 10 here.
My boy goes 10 for 10.
10 for
That's
10.
Absolutely so wrong.
Whatever.
I don't know everything from the 80s.
Yes, you do.
I almost like it when you don't believe in me.
It goes better.
It feels more natural.
It's crawfish week, bruh. Women supporting women. Come on. Let's go, Cupcake.
All right.
Okay, let's see. What is this 80s catchphrase from, Bird?
But I pity the fool.
Oh, it's from the A-Team, Mr. T.
There you go. Very nice.
Okay.
All right. He's rolling me up. He always starts off with a softball.
He wants to get you into a lull of fake confidence.
I think that Kevin Rawson wants me to go 10 for 10 on this one.
Okay. What?
Kevin does. Riggy does not.
No, come on. We're pulling for you here, Bird. Okay, what about this?
Who'd you talking about, Willis?
I mean, it's Arnold Drummond, Different Strokes.
Okay.
His dad was Philip Drummond.
Uh-huh. Look at this guy. Okay.
Rest in peace.
Off now.
Rest in peace. And I personally think Gary Coleman was
murdered.
Oh, what?
Yep. He was married to this scandalous woman.
Just look into the Gary Coleman murder. That's all I'm saying.
Look into their marriage and their relationship. He was pushed down the stairs. You know what happens a lot on Dateline?
Push down the stairs?
Push down the stairs.
Okay.
I'm trying to make sure he's still listening because I know he checks out when I'm talking.
What are you talking about?
I got to quiz him.
What are you talking about, Willis?
What are you talking about, Virginia?
I got to try to keep him involved.
What are you talking about, Witchy?
What are you talking about, Witchy? Okay, what is the source of this 80s catchphrase, Bird?
Go, go, Gadget Legs!
Inspector Gadget.
That is okay. Inspector Gadget.
Inspector Gadget.
Used to love that show.
I had the doll, and that doll, if you want to get it fully loaded with everything in it from the 80s, it's not that cheap.
Okay.
I do not have an
Inspector. Oh, you do not have it?
I don't have an Inspector Gadget. They had a whole Inspector Gadget line that is pretty... All right,
Go, Gadget, go!
What was the name of the girl on Inspector Gadget?
I can't remember.
Oh, Virginia! Do you remember?
Melanie?
Penny.
Penny.
Penny! Yeah.
Penny!
I didn't watch Inspector Gadget a lot.
You didn't? Okay.
I did. I had
the doll, though.
I loved Inspector Gadget.
Okay, what about this one? What is the source of this 80s catchphrase?
I know you are, but what am I?
That's Pee Wee Herman.
That is Pee Wee Herman, yeah.
Okay.
I know you are, but what am I?
I know you are, but what am I?
Oh, man, I was just in stitches when I saw him with that one big top Pee Wee movie. He had a hot dog tree. That's good comedy.
Yep. Hot dog tree's awesome.
All right, perfect so far. What about this one, Jay Bird?
Where's the beef?
That's Where's the Beef is a Wendy's ad. Where's the Beef is Wendy's.
It is Wendy's, yeah.
Yay! Okay. You can't miss a fast food one.
No. I was getting her mixed up with Herb. I don't think you guys remember Herb from Burger King. I brought it up last time, and it did not go well. No one knew what I was talking about.
So, yeah, bring it up again.
That's kind of what I do.
What you talking about?
What you talking about, Willis?
Okay, what about this one? What's the sort of this 80s catchphrase?
Don't be ridiculous.
Don't be ridiculous. That's Balky from Perfect Strangers.
Do you remember his last name?
Balky, no.
Bataka Moose.
Yeah, there we go. Do you credit, though?
Yeah, I'll give you credit. You got Balky.
And the show's name.
Yeah, that was pretty good. Yeah, you get credit, Bird. Okay, what about this old school show? I'm going to take you back. In fact, I think this is early 80s, maybe even late 70s.
Uh-oh. Oh, boy.
Here's where I crap the bed.
Okay. Wilbur go perfect. What is this catchphrase from?
Nanu Nanu.
Nanu Nanu is from Mork and Mindy.
It is. Wow. Yeah, Robin Williams. Very nice.
I had that figure, too. You could buy that figure of Mork, a.k.a. Robin Williams, in an egg, and the egg would break open, and the figure would come out.
Ah,
you can buy that
okay.
in those little things where you put a quarter and what?
You just got so excited.
I know. Did, yeah. By the way,
here's your Hank Pink, Mork Dork.
I am such a dork. I don't care. I lost my mind and I love it.
This catchphrase is from?
How rude.
That is Stephanie Tanner. That is Full House.
Yes, it is. Very nice.
Wow.
Okay, and to go perfect, you have to get this one correct. Bird, what is this from?
I've fallen, and I can't get up.
That's from an infomercial where the old lady falls. It's for the heart thing, where the heart pulse. You hit the button.
Yeah.
The call alert.
What's it called?
Call alert or life alert?
Life alert. Yeah.
Life alert.
Bird.
Wow.
Truth is bulletproof, there's no fooling you. I don't dress the same. Me and who you say I was yesterday have gone our separate ways. Left my living fast somewhere in the past, cause that's for chasing cars. Turns out open bars lead to broken hearts and going way too far. To be young, you tell me time has not changed.
That's 'cause I used to be young. Take one, pour it out, it's not worth crying about the things you can't erase. Like tattoos and regrets, words I never meant and ones that got away. Left my living fast somewhere in the past and took another road. Turns out crowded rooms empty, I'd assume there's somewhere else to go. Be crazy, messed up, but God, was it fun? I know it used to be wild. That's 'cause I used to be young. To be young.
It's not a repeat. It's a replay.
The KVJ replay on 97.9 WRMF.
I know we're a little bit of a ways away from hurricane season, but it's never too early to prepare and get all your stuff right now. And that's why I'm telling you, get ready with Xfinity, because you can stay connected with Xfinity even when the power goes out. It's the first internet provider in the U.S. to keep connected with a backup network. So your storm-ready device will help you extend your Wi-Fi network and eliminate dead spots even when you're not in an outage. And you can stay online during power outage with up to 4 hours of battery backup. Man, I tell you, that makes a huge difference. And you can stay informed about your home network status with the Xfinity app notifications. And the cool thing, it sets up in just minutes to help your home online even during these kind of power outages. All you have to do is call up 1-800-XFINITY or go to Xfinity.com. Restrictions apply. Only available in areas within range of applicable 4G LTE cellular signal. Limited to Xfinity Internet customers with 800 megabits per second of higher and compatible Xfinity gateway. Fully charged Xfinity battery backup will provide up to 4 hours of power to the Xfinity Storm Ready Wi-Fi device.
As a radio stuntman, I do all the extreme stuff in your favorite commercials. But the new Times the Cash scratch-offs are a new level of action-packed. A thrilling multiplier feature, over 15 million prizes that multiply the winnings, and bonus play. They're the most extreme. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to jump this pit of hungry gates for no reason. New Times the Cash scratch-offs from the Florida Lottery. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly.
A true partner in your health dedicates time to understanding your needs. At Conviva Care Center, doctors make one-on-one time with you a priority so you can get all your questions answered and feel more confident in your healthcare. Conviva Senior Care Experts have been helping seniors stay healthy and independent for more than 50 years. Schedule a tour today at tourconviva.com. That's tourconviva.com.
I'm Mark Anajar.
I'm Glenn Levine.
I'm Ellie Anajar.
And we're Anajar and Levine. Experience the Anajar and Levine difference by calling us with any of your legal needs. Call 1-800-747-FREE for a free consultation and take back control of your life.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Every March, Jersey Mike's turns money from subs into charitable donations.
And March 27th is Jersey Mike's annual day of giving, where 100% of sales from every sub are given back to the community.
And to kick off all that giving, Peter gave me an apron. I'm honored.
Looking good, Danny. We've got subs to make, though.
Yeah, now I know why you gave me the apron.
Join us Wednesday, March 27th, for Jersey Mike's Day of Giving. Be a sub above.
You call that a precision stop?
When a rookie stunt driver,
just give me a shot,
meets the trainer who thought he'd seen it all.
Come on, focus.
They'll soon find out that behind the wheel of the Nissan Rogue, with the power of VC Turbo and the most fuel-efficient gas-powered engine in its class,
watch this,
the protege can become a master. But this is no ordinary blockbuster. It's a Nissan sales event ad.
Level up your drive with 1.9% APR financing for 60 months on the 2023 Nissan Rogue. Shop the Nissan sales event. Visit your local Nissan store and NissanUSA.com today. Auto Pacific segmentation excluding hybrids and electric vehicles. 2024 APA fuel economy estimates from 28 City 34 Highway to 30 City 37 Highway for 2024 Nissan Rogue. Actual mileage may vary. For well qualified buyers, 1.9% APR financing for 60 months on new 2023 Rogue and dealer stock. Example, 60 months financing at $1,748 per month per 1,000 financed. Actual down payment may vary. Subject to residency restrictions and NMAC credit approval. Not all buyers qualify. Dealer contribution may affect actual price set by dealer. Contact dealer for details. Ends 4/1/24.
It's mainly clear skies this morning, some patchy fog. Inland temperatures are mild in the low to mid-70s to kick off our Monday, then heating up to high of 90 this afternoon before a few thunderstorms arrive late in the afternoon and evening. A few of those storms could be strong. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
Sponsored by Positive Coaching Alliance.
Got issues with youth or high school sports? Positive Coaching Alliance can help. PCA, a national nonprofit, offers more than 1,000 free online resources for youth and high school sports coaches, parents, students, and administrators. Visit PCADevZone.org.
Now, back to more of the KVJ replay, only on 97.9 WRMF.
Jaybird's a lot of interesting things in his house. If you've ever seen any of the TikTok videos, you definitely know. But when he does inventory, it's kind of interesting to hear just what products he has and how many. He's got a lot of unicorn pencils. I'll put the number at 24. Is the actual number over or under that amount, Virginia?
24 feels like a trick number.
You do good on this game, by the way. And you're going against Denny's? You better not know me better than Sweet Denny's.
Dog.
Keep telling me how good I do.
Yeah, that was a mistake.
I'm going to say more.
You're going to go over. What do you think, Denny's?
Over 24. He does have a lot of unicorn stuff.
He loves unicorns, huh?
Who does?
Well, I'm working on a unicorn, a whole cryptozoology section.
Okay.
And you got to throw unicorn in there. It deserves its place.
Okay. All right.
I'm just thinking about how many they sell packs of pencils. It's usually like 6, 12, 18, even if you bought 3 packs.
He's a man of packs.
He is.
He's a packs man.
I am.
I'm going to say less than.
You're going
to
go
different.
With less than? Virginia's right. He has 64 unicorn pencils. 64 of them.
And the reason why you buy them in bulk is, A, I got a good deal, and you don't want a pencil sharpener. You want to display them as a backdrop.
They're not for writing.
They're not for writing. They're for a backdrop.
Mm-hmm.
A little think piece.
Uh-huh.
Interesting.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking you're losing your mind.
So oh, I'm definitely losing my mind.
You need to get a girlfriend.
I would never bring this kind of crazy into her world.
He's protecting this unknown girl.
I'm protecting her. She doesn't deserve this.
What about fake plastic bonsai trees? Kind of like what was featured in the original Karate Kid.
Exactly like the Karate Kid.
Okay, I've seen these. These are these FAPs, fake-ass plants.
They are awesome, though. Mm-hmm.
He had them all in his room around the perimeter.
Lining his entire room.
Yes. Keeping it sexy.
I got so many compliments on them.
I'll put the number at 10. Denny's. What is the actual number, over or under that?
He's got to have more than 10. I mean, he used to line every room with them and outside.
Yeah.
He's got to have more than 10.
So many FAPs.
More than 10, okay.
He's got to have more than 10.
Okay, you're going to go over. What do you think, Virginia?
I agree with Big D.
Okay, going to go over on that.
Oh!
He's only got 7.
Yeah. A lot got lost in
are
the
move.
Are
you sure you counted right?
You guys are getting them mixed up with my regular FAPs. These are just straight up bonsai.
Oh,
so
straight up bonsai. Specifically
yes.
Bonsai. Oh.
You got a lot of plants around the perimeter.
You tripped me up with your depth.
This game is designed. It's layered.
Damn it, Denny's. We blew it.
Okay, Jaybird's got a lot of Star Wars backpacks.
That was a tough one.
And then I go to fourth period.
Who's the girl you got a crush on?
Her name's Sally. I love her. I hope she loves me back.
I'll put the number at 11. What is the actual number that Jay Bird has? Is it over or under 11, Virginia?
I'm feeling under on this one.
Okay.
It's a fine choice.
What do you think, Denny's?
I'm feeling over.
Okay.
Just because Star Wars, you have so much Star Wars decor, and you wear some. You have that Chewbacca one you wear, the one with Yoda.
You're wearing a Baby Yoda sweatshirt as we speak.
Yeah.
Dang, it's cold in here.
So I'm going to have to say over.
You're going to go over on that. Denny's, you have missed all of them so far.
Man.
It's seven. It's under.
Do you even know me, man?
I'm overestimating all these.
I'm the new Miho.
No,
yeah,
you are not.
The She-Ho. I don't know about that, actually.
She-Ho.
Not really a good name,
no,
but
She-Ho.
Kind of offensive.
We'll take it. We'll take it.
She-Ho. Okay, what about radio station lanyards? I'll put the number at 15. Is the actual number over or under 15, Virginia?
And think about all the weird events we've done.
So many weird events. So many lanyards. But I feel like you usually lose the lanyard at the event.
I say, how many do you keep of those as memorabilia?
That's all. I'm in your heads. Yeah.
You are.
I'm in your head.
You're in there deep.
All right. I want out.
Nope, you're trapped. I'm going to go under.
Going to go under 15, Denny's?
I'm going to go over, only in the case that he kept them by accident. They're in a box and he just found a bunch.
Okay.
So I'm going to go on that.
Good choice.
That's okay. Exactly what happened. Right. Denny's is so right. They were in a box from moving, and they are some crappy lanyards. Not even from our fun events.
I keep only the bad ones.
Yeah, I do.
He's got 24 radio station lanyards.
Look,
I will say
you.
There's a few duplicates in there.
Okay,
final one here. How many different types of canned frosting does Jay Bird have at his house?
Currently,
right now. I'll put the number at 15.
Oh, my God.
15?
No way he's got 15. Canned frosting?
Yeah, canned frosting.
Yeah, we're
going to
come over after
frosting.
The show. We're going to count.
I would love that, actually. That would be a frosting party, and I'm so here for it.
Yeah. Don't tease him with a good
time.
Yeah,
now we're having a frosting party.
Yeah.
15.
Yeah.
And they're open or unopened? Does it matter?
No, it doesn't. They could be
15.
Yeah.
Mixed bag.
Yeah, different states of.
Some are like pre-COVID, probably.
Mm-hmm.
I love hearing you guys.
I can see them. But are there 15?
That's what I can see a fair amount, even in your wildest, which you ever buy 15 of those.
I am a cake-making she-ho, and I don't even have 15. I've got a lot of frosting at any given time.
We're talking about just cake frosting.
Yeah.
The little plastic,
just
Duncan Hines, Pillsbury.
Yeah, stuff you put on a cake.
Pre-made frosting, which, by the way, at Publix right now, they're BOGO.
Publix got a lot of BOGO going on.
They got a BOGO on frosting. I was just there last night because today is Panda's birthday.
So did Bird buy BOGO? Is that why he's got so many?
Did he buy BOGO?
Could be.
Oh, gosh. Golly, we don't want to blow it, Kevin. We take this very serious.
That's right, Kevin.
All right, you're at 15. Over or under that amount, Denny's?
We take a 3-minute bit and make it 15.
I know, it's long.
Kevin's trying to get to Bird.
It's an art form.
it's our thing. It's, you know.
Oh, apprehensively, I'm going to say less than 15. I just find that so many.
It's a lot. It's a lot of frosting.
Ugh, the tone, though, I hear. It sounds like.
What do you think, Virginia?
I mean, I guess I got to try to be different from Denny's. If he's going under, I'll go over, but not with confidence.
Okay, the actual number is 11. It is under Denny's.
Wow, yes, look at you.
We get a tie.
Finish strong, Denny's.
I can feel it.
Two apiece.
1, 2, 3, My baby don't mess around because she loves me so, and this I know for sure. Together, 'cause we don't know how.
why yo? Are we so in denial when we know we're not happy here? Y'all don't wanna hear me, you just wanna dance.
Date will last 51 minutes before somebody throws out an excuse. It's almost like a penalty flag in football. And like, I gotta bounce, gotta go. So how long is it for you on average? And what was the moment when you realized you needed to go? And then what kind of excuse or escape plan? Did you come up with something lame or just say, that's gross, I gotta bounce?
Or were you like Jay Bird and you just got lucky and the cops intervened and took your girl away in handcuffs?
So nice, yeah.
I mean, you really didn't have to do anything. You just sit back, enjoy the show, and the cops finish it for you.
And then I walked back to my apartment going, what the hell just happened?
Jenna said, I was with a guy, went through the whole date, about 90 minutes, and what did it for me? He started eating crumbs off the table. He would, like, wipe them off, and then he would throw them into his mouth.
Yeah, my buddy said he went on a date with this, he was with this girl, and they were eating, and she ordered corn, and I guess she got corn stuck in her teeth, so she goes in her purse and brings out a business card and starts picking the corn out of her teeth with the business card at the table. He couldn't believe it. He really couldn't believe it.
Was she just trying to get a free meal?
Virginia, I wasn't there.
She might be doing like how to lose a guy in 10 days on him. I think just purposely trying to be awful.
If I remember, I still think she hit him up after.
Really?
Yeah, man. It was bizarre.
She wanted more corn.
How gnarly is that?
Did he buy her corn?
I can't remember.
He probably paid for the meal, and she probably was like, all right, this is how I'm going to get free corn.
It was a date. It was a real date, yeah. And he said he just was shocked at what happened.
We got a text here. It says, my best friend called me from a restaurant bathroom to come pick her up real quick when her date brought his ex-girlfriend with him.
What?
Yeah, it's a pretty good reason to end a date.
On the date?
Yeah.
What kind of weird game are they playing?
That's odd, man. That's really odd.
It happens, y'all.
Bunch of drinking ones as well. Somebody said, I got a rule of never doing dinner on the first day, only drinks. I had a date a few years ago, and we both knew immediately we weren't into each other. And when the bartender asked if we wanted a second round, we're both like, nope.
Nope, we're good.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's cool if you both can say that and
Be coy. I don't like you. You don't like me.
Yeah. If you have any kind of doubts that it's not going to be good, you should do coffee because that's even quicker than drinks. Say, look, I'll meet you at Dunkin'. We'll get a little coffee action. That's 20 minutes.
I do love the fact that you plugged Dunkin', but I think coffee dates are weird, man.
Yeah.
A day coffee date is odd to me.
Not if you drink coffee. Most people drink coffee and they're like, yeah, okay, that's cool. And you're letting them know, I'm not here to make some big commitment to something that's not going to work out.
Is there any difference between meeting somebody at a Starbucks or a brewery?
Yes, there is a difference.
Uh-huh.
Because one's alcohol. And you
might have multiples at a brewery.
Yeah, hey, you get a buzz.
You're not going to drink multiple coffees.
I don't want, if I'm not sure that I'm going to like him, I don't want to have beers with him because then the beers might trick me into thinking I like him.
I don't know. You keep drinking multiple coffee and it does, you guys do hit off. A, now you've got bad coffee breath and you're probably going to crap yourself. Right? It's a diuretic, no?
Doesn't it make you? Do you poop yourself off in Virginia after drinking coffee?
No.
Okay.
I've heard some horror stories.
I have butt control. Apparently, my buddy over here to the left is not.
I have the best BC.
I gotta tell you, if I drank coffee and I pooped my pants, it'd be my last cup of coffee. That's when I realized, yeah.
That is some vicious coffee.
Stay away from that liquid.
And don't paint me with that brush. I've got fantastic BC.
Okay.
Prove it.
One text said, I met somebody at Funky Buddha for our first date. He showed up late, stumbled in, admitted to taking Percocet and having four beers before he came.
Oh, my gosh. We don't even need to finish talking. We're done.
Yeah, he was loud, obnoxious. I hadn't even finished my first beer. I'm like, look, I'm not feeling this. And I just left. He called and texted me dozens of times that night, called me all sorts of names.
Oh, my gosh. What a nightmare.
Dodged a bullet.
Yeah. No, that's tough. And I will tell you, though, just hearing what my daughter does, a lot of times she'll pregame before a date, and I know...
I don't like that, I love drinking. Nobody is a bigger proponent than me of getting a buzz on, but I don't want them to be intoxicated, and I don't want to be intoxicated. I want to see what they're about.
Right.
They got a 20-minute window to either impress me or not, and then I want out.
I think you're so right. You don't want to do... You don't want to... I mean, a drink, maybe to take the nerves down a little bit.
I don't want that.
I'm just saying, but to your point, getting too tipsy is not the right move before a date.
I agree. I was like, I don't know. I get it. That
it's about nervousness.
Yeah,
and for that
is.
Reason, I do get it.
Yeah.
But you do yourself a disservice when you're not in clear mind and they're not in clear mind. And if it's really somebody you want to date, you need to look at it and do it in clear mind. If not.
Yep.
You're doing this on purpose, and you're self-sabotaging your relationships, which is a deeper problem there.
That's true. All right.
Coffee day dates.
Nah, Bert ain't feeling it.
Poopy Pennington doesn't like that coffee date.
For a while there, it was rough, but lately I've been doing better than the last four cold Decembers I recall. And I see my family every month. I found a girl my parents love. She'll come and stay the night, and I think I might have it all. And I thank God every day for the girl he sent my way. But I know the things he gives me, he can take away. And I hold you every night, and that's a feeling I wanna get used to. But there's no man as terrified as the man who stands to lose you. Oh, I hope I don't lose you. Please stay. I want you, I need you, oh God. Don't take these beautiful things that I've got. Please stay. I want you, I need you, oh God. Don't take these beautiful things that I've got. Oh. Please.
found my mind, I'm feeling insane. It's been a while, but I'm finding my faith. If everything's good and it's great, why do I sit and wait till it's gone? Oh, I tell you, I know I've got enough. I've got peace and I've got love. But I'm up at night thinking I just might lose it all. You, I need you, oh God. I need these beautiful things that I've got.
Because you just can't get enough KVJ. The KVJ replay on 97.9 WRMF.
The Cooling Advisors team is amazing. Family owned and operated. Over 70 years of experience. They know ACs inside and out. And they want to put you in the cooling club. Now, what that means for you is you get regular service and maintenance of your equipment, which keeps you ahead of the game, keeps your system functioning at the top notch. And when you do these regular tune-ups with Cooling Advisors, you can save yourself as much as 30% on energy costs over the year. Yeah, it really does help increase the productivity and decrease the amount of power you use. Keep up with it. Join the Cooling Club from Cooling Advisors, your AC experts. They're locally owned by a family right here, not some big corporation from out of town. They background screen and drug test all of their employees. CoolingAdvisors.com. It's the family owned and operated AC company that you're going to love. CoolingAdvisors.com.
I'll tell you, there's never been a better time to upgrade to a new Kia. It's Nick Rivers. With inventory levels the best they've been in years, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach highly motivated to make some deals that other dealers won't. Drive home in a new 2024 Kia Forte for only $219 a month. 24-month lease with $27.99 due at signing. Plus, all new Kias come with a 10-year, 100,000-mile limited warranty. Are you unsure about your credit? Forget it. Get pre-qualified online without affecting your credit score at GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. Plus, hey, they want your old car. Bring in any trade. Get up to a $5,000 discount off any select new Kia stocks only at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS, follow them on Facebook or online. GreenwayKiaWestPalmBeach.com. And remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Qualified applicants through KMF, 10,000 miles per year, security deposit waived, plus tax, tag, and $9.99 admin fee. Negative equity refinance. Discount includes all factory rebates to dealer. Warranty is a limited powertrain warranty. See Kia.com or retailer for details. Offers don't combine. Expires May 5th.
Man, I'm telling you, the difference it makes when you switch out your windows and doors. I did it, and it took me 3 years to do it because I paid it off in phases. BNT will work with you, just like they worked with me. If you don't have all money up front, you can break it up into three phases like I did. And now, bam, here I am. Last year was my first hurricane season with my house completely fortified courtesy of BNT Windows and Doors. Every window, every door, hurricane ready. It just gave me a sense of peace I had never had before. I got to tell you, it was kind of nice to be like, well, I've done everything I can to fortify this home. Whatever happens, happens. It did give me peace. You want that peace too. Get it for yourself. Call BNT. You know, they use custom PGT products, and PGT makes the best-selling window and door on the market. Go online today. BNT Windows and Doors.
Strax Aesthetics unlocks the secret to great cosmetic surgery. Have surgery now and pay later. Breast augmentations and tummy tucks less than $150 per month for qualified patients. Extreme weight loss with a gastric sleeve procedure. The Strax Med Spa offers Botox for $9.99 per unit and unbeatable prices on Juvederm. Guaranteed to beat any comparable quote. Schedule a free face-to-face consultation with your actual board-certified surgeon. Saturday appointments available too. Visit StraxPlastics.com or call 954-749-3040 for more info.
It's a groovable feast at Universal Mardi Gras, February 3rd through April 7th.
Enjoy the international flavors of Carnival with an ice-cold Coca-Cola Zero Sugar at the hottest party in town. This is your bead-throwing, concert-going, non-stop festival of fun.
Florida residents, get 2 days free when you buy a two-park, one-day park-to-park ticket. Dig into the details at UniversalOrlando.com. Not available at front gate. Used by 6/26/24. Restrictions apply.
Business. It's not a 9-to-5 proposition. It's all day and into the night. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these businesses is a partner like Comcast Business helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide. All these businesses choose the advanced network, cybersecurity solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business. From Main Street to Wall Street, our people are powering the businesses that power it all. So when you're ready to unlock what's possible for your business, there's no one better to answer the call. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Restrictions apply. Call or visit ComcastBusiness.com to learn more.
Experience the Anager and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
They keep it real. The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Wanting, but no flashing lights. Oh.
nothing but more.
The KVJ replay continues right now, only on 97.9 WRMF.
So what is that song that you just never, ever get sick of? That is just always great, and every single time, like, going, oh my gosh, I can listen to this time and time again. I've got a pocket of those songs that every time I hear it, it's just like, oh my gosh, it's just the best thing ever. I would never hit forward if it came through on streaming.
There are certain songs that I've been listening since I was a child that I'll still go back and listen to. And it's almost as if I pick new things up out of it. That blows my mind.
I think some of them, too, they're just so ingrained with good memories that every time you do, it's just kind of that endorphin rush of you feel great. And you're just like, oh, man. And to you, at least, it is maybe the perfect song.
And don't you love when it happens? And this doesn't always happen. You'll be walking somewhere, maybe you're in Publix, or maybe you're and you hear a song for the first time. You've never heard it before, but just that first time, you fall in love love it first year.
Mm-hmm. It's a beautiful thing.
Every time I'm in Publix, I know that song. Every song they play is a banger. Whoever put together Publix playlist, y'all know what y'all doing.
I'm not gonna lie, my Publix time is probably 15 minutes. I overstay because of the playlist.
I'm always that person. They're singing, and then somebody will look at you like, shut up, and I just keep singing.
Like, oh, there's that annoying Virginia.
With that witch-ass voice.
I have to tell you, I think Whole Foods is better.
Oh, get out of here. You are crazy.
Their playlist, you think, is better?
They play a lot of Muse.
I don't know.
Too cool for the world.
Coldplay.
As you're buying $45 tomatoes,
Whole Foods is a better
playlist. Why is this tomato $45, Kevin?
I don't care. I'm not gonna stick up for that, but I will tell you the music's better.
You gotta afford those music rights. That's why the tomatoes.
Whole Foods thinks it's too cool.
Yeah, dude, turn up the B-side of Muse as
it's
I'm
better.
$58 for pineapple, everybody.
It's better playlist.
Price check on pineapple. Oh, it's $300.
Regular people can't shop at Whole Foods. I'm just saying.
Oh, when I'm going to Whole Foods, it's vacation time.
Or I just got a bonus.
Just got a paycheck. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what is that song that you never get sick of? That's what we have today for the playlist playoff. Here is my three.
Say what you say.
Oasis.
Say that you stay forever and a day in the time of my life. Does it need more time? Yes, I need more time just to make things right.
Casper Cutie. You hear this song at Whole Foods.
You hear this one at Publix.
As you're giving them so much money.
Duran Duran.
What is this, Kevin? Sex song right here.
It is, yeah. Summer of Kev. That's three songs I'd never get sick of.
Don't Go Away by Oasis is such a great
it
song.
It really is.
Oh, I love that song.
It's next level.
That's you. You're flying out. The plane's going into the sky. That song just goes on.
Yeah, the clouds are all around you. Oh, it's just a beautiful setting.
Yeah. You don't want to get a drink after this?
That playlist makes me want to drink.
No, bro, I don't feel good.
Yeah, I don't want to drink anything else.
I just had the grossest milkshake of my life. The last thing I want to do is go drink. I need to go lay.
Me and Kevin will get some drinks and you can get some Pepto.
I need to go make a number two.
I feel like my stomach is expanding.
That's I don't rough. Feel right.
No, I don't either. Somebody fake punched me. I don't even know what happened.
Okay, here's Virginia's playlist of the song you never get sick of. The Weeknd.
Oh, are you too with the sex music?
It's the perfect time of year.
Oh, yeah. This could have made my list,
such
too.
Such a chill
somewhere
song.
Somewhere far away from here. I feel fine enough, I guess. Considering everything's a mess.
Chelsea,
Super chill song.
I love The Killers, and I'm surprised at how popular that song is. It's so massively popular.
It's so insane. Good. Yeah. You can't help but tap your little toes.
It does. It's a grooving song, man.
They have some of my oldest son went to the school in Michigan, and their football games, they play that song.
Puck is off.
Everybody sings, like, verbatim. And, you know, he's 24?
Yeah.
So the young kids love that song.
It's got everything you want in a song.
It really does.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here's where the room turns.
No. It'll turn again on me.
But I'm going with the ones that are true. Yeah. These are songs I've never gotten sick of, and I've heard them a billion times.
Can we predict the artist?
Go for it.
Billy Joel.
Billy Joel's Vienna's got to be in here. Or Summer Highland Falls. Or both.
Both. Yeah. And then a James Taylor song.
No, I know James Taylor makes everyone really angry, so I...
Okay, here's what Bird's got for these songs he never gets sick of.
Now I have seen that sad surrender.
There you go.
Billy.
Summer Highland Falls.
Big Ball Billy.
I can only stand apart and sympathize. For we are always what our situations hand us. See the sadness all. But you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want, or you can just get old, you're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? Day after day.
Oh, man. Great song.
Night after night, my heartbeat shows the fear. Ghosts appear and fade.
That is such a great song. Yeah.
I
come
love
back
that
another day.
I've never gotten sick of that song.
I gotta add that to my list too.
It's a good one.
Never get sick of that one. And here we go with Denny's for the playlist playoff. Fair the songs he never gets sick of.
I'm a little bit more alternative than you guys.
Don't tell me you put it Because I Got High in there.
No, but I do love that song.
Oh, and I got to fight with the chat room.
Temper Trap, you guys know the song?
Oh my gosh, I know this song.
I love this song.
This is a great song.
This one I know you like, Ben.
Oh, yeah. High and Dry, baby.
I love this song.
Radiohead. Great song.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's a good song.
It's their only hit.
Yeah. Good stuff. Dang. Well, you guys all got good songs.
I let everybody have good songs. I put together a Spotify playlist of everybody.
You had good songs.
You had good songs.
I stand by my songs.
That's a lot of butt kissing.
I'm fighting with the chat room. This sucks. No, it doesn't.
Bert, don't read the comments.
I like to be involved with the people.
You love your songs.
I don't ignore our audience.
You love Billy Joel, even though it's a little tired at this point.
That's what this is. It's about it. It'll be tired lists.
Not working hard. Yeah, right. Picture that.